Are we live?
We're live.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome. This is Twitch Game Night, where you get to play board games with the crew here, us. This is our weekly Kingdom Death Monster stream, where we do a continuing campaign of Kingdom Death Monster. We're currently in Lantern Year 7?
Yes.
7. I'm really bad at remembering what year it is.
You better remember everything.
Okay, whatever. We'll go with that. But first, a quick introduction for everyone. I'm Matt.
I'm Josh.
I'm TP, which means you guys play.
And you speak up a little bit.
You guys play, and I control the board.
Mike is not by you today, so you speak up.
Ah, there it is. All the way over there. Okay, projection mode on.
Exactly. Projection mode on. But so, anyway, Josh, do you want to give us a reminder of what happened last week?
Last week, we went out, we fought the Flower Knight.
That was a good fight.
That was a good fight.
Thank you, Tolkien. Sorry.
We did all right. Mo did get -2 speed, which kind of sucks. On the way back, Mo also got the Twilight Sword. So that was handed off to Mo.
Which is pretty terrible for the guy with bow specialization to get stuck with that.
But not
too terrible.
It's not horrible. We had Rivalry.
I'm sorry, what?
Rivalry! As our settlement event,
yeah.
And Mo and Trump went to each other's throats.
Yes.
And you need to try to get rid of that.
Yes,
so
we do.
I believe we have 5 endeavors left, if you can do Kitty Poles Twitch.
Kitty Poles.
And if you just open it up to once you do it, and just tell me what it says at the top. I think it says you have 5 endeavors left. It might be 4, but I think it's 5.
Oh, we'll find out. You can certainly try.
Yeah.
Ooh, it's hot.
I actually think it's quite comfortable in here.
Four left? Alright. So, we can try Rivalry twice.
I'm sorry, what was that?
We can try doing the endeavor for this twice.
For what?
Stop.
I'm sorry. I just enjoy hearing you mispronounce it.
I'm gonna knock you in the face.
Let's try to get rid of Rivalry, but then something bad could happen.
It can.
Something very bad could happen.
Something very, very bad could happen.
Thanks,
So can you get the queue up for people to join?
She just did.
Better did.
Yeah.
And Cage, I'm not blonde yet because we're going to be speaking at a panel in front of people in person. And
hey, Alex and Sam's here.
I'm not comfortable screwing up my hair before them.
Alex and Sam says, "Who is the clean-shaven, handsome chap on the right?"
Did they really?
Yes, they did.
Thank you.
And he is single, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, am I?
Just kidding.
Is that free reign for me?
No. Yeah, if you can get on it, jump on it.
Ew.
But you all heard that. That was permission.
Yeah, it was permission.
No, I'm crossing my fingers. That count.
And also yesterday Charles donated or tipped some money for a couple survivor names.
He
so
did.
If we have a couple new survivors, we have our first 3 names set already.
Okay. Those are going to be the next 3 names in general, even if we don't make 3 survivors today.
Yes. So if it's next stream or whenever it is, that those names will be used.
Great Hour wants to know why you looked at me when you said that.
You're the names? Or that?
No.
Oh.
Hey, Mark. That you're single?
Yeah. No.
Because he's not. He's taken.
Oh, that's right. Vital Genius Games does have a survivor name, I believe. That
yeah.
He took from a while ago.
Yeah, so.
So if you want to, Vital Genius Games, if you want to send us a name.
What you want.
We need a name.
Well, add to the list.
Or we can just name it Mark.
Mr. Freckles says, don't you now have to drop everything and play Exploding Kittens? We did that!
We played Exploding Kittens after they left again.
Exploding Kittens, they go to leave. Alex and Sam, stick around for the entry.
So Vital Genius Games is asking for Riga.
Riga. Okay.
And Alex and Sam said, no, they're good with this.
Aw, okay. Thanks, Alex and Sam.
We owe you one, though. We promise.
So we have that going on.
So I think that we should spend our first 2 endeavors to do Rivalry, to try and get rid of it. It's up to you guys, though, if you want to toss in a suggestion, if you want to vote yes for that or no, just scream it in chat and let us know. And we have something really fun to tell you guys. So we have a giveaway we're going to be doing today, because we hit our viewership goal of 600 followers.
Yes.
Actually, a little bit ago, but the reason we waited for this stream is it is a Kingdom Death Monster giveaway, themed giveaway.
Yeah.
We're giving away the Sci-Fi Twilight Knight minifigure that is signed by Adam Poots.
It is.
So a little bit of a nice little exclusive content. Not exclusive, but... Yeah.
But it's one of a kind.
It is one of a kind.
Well,
it's also signed to TGN, too, so...
It is. What?
No, because the other one's different.
Oh, that's right. You're right.
They're 2 different figures.
You're right. But yeah, so we have the Sci-Fi Twilight Night we're giving away. So if you're not familiar with our giveaway system, we have Revlobot in there screaming at you guys. That's what he does best. But you can gain 1 point for every minute that you watch our stream, and you can redeem 25 points for a ticket. That's exclamation mark ticket.
Ticket, space one.
Space how many? How many internet on page? Douchebag Final Genius Games tipped, so I had to dye my hair blonde. It didn't work out yet, so I have to keep doing it, but no more internet Alan Page.
Oh god, when you shave your beard, Matt, give away its remains. What do you mean when I shave my beard? When did this become a discussion? This is the beautiful thing that's staying here.
Discord talked about shaving your balls. Or waxing your balls.
Okay, let's move on.
Let's move. Moving right along.
I'll do it, I promise.
You want to mention the cool cups we have?
But yeah, so we got some really awesome cups, courtesy of Loaded Dice. They're a Kickstarter that's currently live right now, and I really do love these.
Yeah,
so just a shout out to them. We're whoring ourselves out for a minute here.
Well, technically we're not, because...
No, but I really do enjoy these cups, and honestly the full set I'm probably going to wind up buying them.
Oh yeah, I mean, I thought it was cool in passing when I saw it. Now that I actually have my hands on it, like, it's fucking awesome. I need them all. Yes, I have. Now that I have my hands on it. Hang on, let me put it in my mouth.
Vile Genius Games. Hey, who brought them to you? I think it was Santa.
Yeah, it was Santa.
It was
in the red outfit.
Yeah,
it
was some guy dressed
red
in
dress.
Red. No, but Mark of Vile Genius Games brought them over to us. We had a stream last night. If you guys haven't checked it out yet, go check out our Spotlight stream. It's on Twitch, and we're going to be uploading it to YouTube.
It's already on YouTube.
It's already on YouTube.
Yeah.
So it was a spotlight stream of Hearthstone Tavern, Legends of Goblins Past. Very fun game that's currently live on Kickstarter, too.
It is. You guys should go check it out. Let me see if I can get the link or if Mark can beat me to it.
If you do exclamation point game,
nope.
Should do it.
Nope.
But we're also going to be doing, I think, another stream of that on Monday. And then on the 30th, we're going to do a drinking version of it.
Right. So we're going to be doing a much more condensed stream next Monday.
We're going to focus. We're not really going to play with chat so much as, like, actually power through the game, play it the way it's meant to be played, have a lot of fun. Thank you, Mark, for pimping yourself out there.
And then we're going to be doing the drinking variant of the game, where the game really does lend itself to the drinking variant. It's set in a bar, and it's a bunch of people telling, you know, tales about that. But
Tales of Goblins.
Tales of Goblins, yeah. But yeah, so otherwise, let's get back to the mainstream here. We'll pimp your stuff out a little bit again, we promise. But so, I saw a couple people say that they wanted to do the
rivalry,
getting rid of the rivalry there. So,
Can we get the first person in the queue?
If you want to join the queue, exclamation point, join at any time. Ooh, any pledges that come from tonight's stream, TGN gets 10%. I like that. Pledge now. If you were going to wait till the end, don't wait till the end.
Do it now.
Pledge now. And I think it's fair enough that because if it's generated from the stream, we'll count it towards tips for new goals.
So, Valkyrie, I really can't help you out there because we've never fought the Dung Beetle or the Sunstalker. So,
nope.
I really...
We have not fought either of them.
Not sure there.
What was the question?
He said they're undergeared and they... two people achieved their gear in the last 4 years. Can't decide fighting between the Flower Knight for a second bow, Dung Beetle, or Sunstalker. You say second bow.
Dung Beetle's supposed to be difficult.
Yeah. If you have the... Vespertine bow already, which I think that's the way he made it sound. Just go after the Flower Knight and get some gear from him. You can take him down pretty easily if you have the sniper bow.
Didn't we fight the Dung Beetle last time? Right?
No,
we fought the
Flower Knight. We did the intro for the Dung Beetle, but we actually never got around to fighting
him. We did all the stories besides everything for the Lion God. We did all the story events, but we did not fight everything.
Valkyrie wants to know if the Sunstalker is easier than the Dung Beetle.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know.
I have no idea. Dung Beetle Knight's, like, one of the hardest characters. Like, so I'll tell you what Zenith said. Zenith says level 3 Dung Beetle Knight might not be beatable. That's what he said.
Yeah, he says he's not exactly sure if it's 100% within the realm of possibility.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's like, you can gear yourself in whatever you want. I'm not sure if you can beat it. So,
okay, so we
get
need
the next
first
person
in the queue, TP.
I'm sorry, yes.
Yeah.
And we need them to roll a d10, please.
I believe it's going to be Newt. Newt is always the first person. It's between
Newt
and Cage.
No, Cage is always.
Newt's right up there.
Inquiring Newt, I just put together the Sunstalker and Mind God. My God, they're big models. Newt rolled a 9. Oh,
okay.
Wow, that's actually a fantastic
thing.
It's the
best thing that can happen.
You go Newt. So after hours of fighting, this was Mo...
Mo and Trump,
okay. After hours of fighting with no one taking the upper hand, Mo and Trump develop a grudging respect for each other. The settlement gains the partnership innovation. If neither survivor has the partnership skill, both gain it naming each other as partners. Wait a minute. So did Trump just get married to Mo?
Kind of, but I think they're both females. So, yeah, they're both females.
Okay, so Trump is now in a lesbian relationship with Mo.
Yep.
Cool.
So I need to get the partnership.
Did TGN miss my comment? Possibly.
Who said
what? No, we saw yours, the 10%.
Oh, yeah. No, I told everyone, do it now.
Do it now.
Do it now.
Please. Okay, so that was a fantastic outcome there. So props to that for Nudie Nudie.
So we have 2 endeavors left.
Yeah, and we just got a free innovation, essentially.
Yeah, we got a free innovation, which is awesome also.
I will read it, because you can't read.
I can't read.
So, partnership. If you spend 2 endeavors, you nominate 2 survivors. They pair off, and each gains the partner ability. So we actually just got that for Trump and Mo.
Newt says Trump is now Lesbo and Hillary's body.
That is correct, actually.
That's factual.
Yeah.
Everything is...
So, partner. When you both depart, so when Trump and Mo depart together, they gain +2 survival. While adjacent to each other, they get +1 strength. Partners may only nominate each other for intimacy.
Which doesn't really work for the two of them.
It doesn't. So when a partner dies, the remaining partner gains a random disorder and loses this ability. Oh, there you go. So Alpha Decay says, time for the belt of gender change for Mo.
Or for Donald to become a man again.
I mean, yeah, you could do that.
There's no way Trump would voluntarily be a woman. He's too misogynistic.
Okay, right,
so partner with
Mo and Trump. So when they are next to each other, they get +1 strength, and when they depart together, they get +2 survival each. So the story of the Trump, he eats Poop Wiener's skull, gets murdered by an angry mob for it, his mind invades Hillary's brain and takes over, and then has lesbian relationships despite his family being in the settlement.
Yes.
That's accurate.
100%.
That is 100% accurate.
Okay.
So we have 2 endeavors left.
So, try to make 2 babies?
Baby time?
Make Trump male again. Hashtag make Trump male again.
Well, let's make 1 baby, and then we can see if we want to do leather work.
Oh, yeah, let's do that.
So we're going to do 1 baby, so TP the next person from the queue, and we're going to have them roll on the augury. And I forget what that roll is. Who are we nominating?
We've been nominating someone.
We should make that trend on Twitter. Make Trump male again. Hashtag make Trump male again. That would be fantastic. Cag rolled a 4. That is definitely not a success, I believe.
It's +1 survival.
+1 survival, yeah.
It is. I can't remember who we're using for it. I think we're using John?
Inquiring Newt. I just realized we lost 2 females from breeding.
Yes, we did.
Yeah, that's upsetting.
It's alright.
This is KDM Trump. This Trump is a hero of the people, making our settlement great again. That's right, Dixon. What are you looking for?
Who were we using? I think we were using John.
We were using Elvis, but Elvis died.
Ah. John has 2 understanding, so he would be...
John Cena.
Yeah, John Cena.
Yeah.
So I think he'll be next, so he'll get
a
survival.
Okay, so John Cena will get 2 survival, or a
One
survival?
A survival.
So, TP, can you pull the Katie poll again and see what quarry we're going to be fighting? Because that's going to determine how we use our last endeavor. Oh, Alpha Decay says, rather than building new testicles, you could always just give them the frenzy potion.
That's true.
So, TP, what does it look like we're going to be departing against?
We are departing against...
I hope it's the Gorm.
No, it's not the
ground. Oh. Inquired Nude. Hey, everyone, join the queue tonight. You don't mean making all the rolls.
And Late Night Tabletop is hosting us.
Hey, thank
you, Late
Night Tabletop.
Better if you can link.
Hey, then they just said hi. Hey, Late
Hello.
Night.
Hello.
Also, 18 pop equals wow.
Screaming Antelope and Flower Knight are both 10.
Ooh. What do you want to fight again? I think Flower Knight would be good.
Issue of Flower Knight is all the resources are perishable.
That is true. But we got the Vespertine Bow, so we could really wreck his shit.
We could wreck his shit, but like, I think we could get some better resources from
Screaming Antelope.
Yeah. And it's a fight we haven't done on stream yet.
That's true. Okay, so let's do Screaming Antelope.
Alright.
We're going to do Streaming and Streaming
so,
Antelope.
Streaming him. We are Streaming the Antelope.
The Antelope.
So we're going to do the Leatherworker then? Is that...
Yeah, we're going to be doing the Leatherworker.
Okay, so I'm using the two blooms, and then we have a scrap bloom that goes away because it's perishable.
Things and stuff.
One hide
stuff
here. So we have two hides left, and I'm going to get rid of the acid gland.
Little card that I can just text the visibility of the text. I have no gear.
Give her a gear
random
card.
You should have one right over there.
I don't have any gear cards.
It's in that pile there.
There's no gear cards in this pile.
No.
A gear card. Gear card. He didn't get it.
No.
I already gave her that.
Oh, I thought you were talking
no,
about...
Not a gear grid.
Whatever.
Gear card. Time to get that terse neck meat from the antelope. Oh, right. Yeah. Terse neck
so...
meat.
So... But Leatherworker, let me get the Leatherworker out.
You said butt.
He did say butt. I heard it. I can get butt.
So hopefully we get some more hide and then we can make some leather.
Leather is... Well, the leather shield is nice.
Leather shield's nice. We do have the... we do have a shield though, so...
That is true. Well, we have that weird knuckle shield.
Yeah. But
the
knuckle
shield.
Leather armor set is nice for the resistance to bash.
Late night tabletop. Neck meat. My favorite.
That is my favorite as well.
Is that because Josh has a lot of it?
Yes, it is.
Alright, who is departing?
Yeah, so we need the departing
and grab
survivors.
The name while we do that.
Give me 1 second. I'm just trying to screw with the...
And we're going to fight a level 1 antelope, because...
You want to fight a level 3 antelope to start out with?
No.
That level 3 lion wasn't very nice.
Oh no, he was not.
Ooh, Twilight Cloak of Tars now. I don't know if I can get away with that. But it was a contestant.
You guys are probably playing Trump, so you're probably getting that. So.
Yay! Okay, so we are going to see... And what was the question? Survivors
who
survivors?
Are the departing survivors?
No, already? I want to make movies.
There,
we
used
didn't
all
have
our...
all much for endeavors.
Okay,
so we needed to get rid of the...
The rivalry.
The rivalry.
Okay, but... did you write down his name that he wants for the next baby?
Mark and Riga, and we have the three from Charles Fox
yeah.
as well.
Okay.
So Riga, R-I-G-A?
R-I-G-G-A.
Kev Wright says, Josh's neck meat gives TP plenty of purchase for grass grid during extracurriculars.
Okay.
That is completely right, though, Ikoi. Why fight the level 3 lion when you can fight the Beast of Sorrow?
Beast of Sorrow is so awesome.
We farmed the hell out of the Beast of Sorrow.
If we get Beast of Sorrow, that's pretty much all we
so
did.
So good.
Okay, so departing survivors, you need 4, correct?
Yes.
We need the top 4.
We're going to go Donald Trump.
So that's going to be you guys.
And that gear grid should be
so
what you're wearing. So.
I just remember that you have the Red Fist secret fighting art.
Yes. You also have the Swordsman.
Which is max survival when you depart with sword.
Yeah, so they'll get 4 survival at the beginning of the showdown. We'll all get +1 strength token.
And then the trick's not really that great.
They can give someone priority token.
Yeah. So, this is for you, TP.
Gracias. I'm going to put this over here by me. Just because
yeah, that's fine. So, who is next, TP?
Next, it is going to be... Does Trump have the flower disorder?
No,
he
does not.
He got rid of that. Because
okay.
he fought the flower knight. She got rid of that last year. Because they fought.
Matt is sabotage. Matt.
Hold on. Matt shaves his head when I crit.
Yes.
Okay. Matt is sabotage. Okay.
And finally, we have a tie between Stalin and Despair. I think maybe we should ask if they wanted to send Mo now that if Mo and Trump depart together, they get extra stuff.
They get +2 survival each. However, Trump automatically gets +, max survival because of the gear. And
the strength isn't worth anything, really.
The strength isn't worth anything because Mo is a ranged character, so Mo's kind of going to be in a different spot than Trump most of the time.
And Mo now has minus two speed, which really, really sucks.
Oh, so.
Very much sucks.
Screw that then. All right, so actually it's a tie between Stalin, Despair, and Bill Clinton. I'm thinking Bill.
Bill
has a...
Seizures. Any head injuries gets him knocked down.
Let's not go with Bill.
No, that's fine. We can send Bill.
We can make him the range guy.
Yeah, that's fine.
And you shouldn't get knocked down.
I kind of want to play as Bill Clinton, then.
Priority messes up the antelope a fair bit. If I remember correctly, it likes to target furthest away to trample down people.
It's been a very long time since we fought the antelope.
Yeah,
so.
It's been a very long time since we fought the antelope.
Bellville says, by the way, TP is officially Twitch Panda now.
Accurate.
Fair enough.
Okay, so what's the board setup?
Hold on.
So I'm playing as the two Matt characters?
You're going to play as Matt Chase's Head in That Crit and Matt is Sabotage.
Just because Matt wants to play with the Vespering Bow. Because he's.
I love that Vesper team bow. It's so nice. Okay, so Josh, we need the Hunt.
They're in front of you, the Hunt cards.
Okay, perfect. Thank you, Joshua.
TP, do you have open grids on your thing?
Do you have any open spaces on your gear grid, TP?
What?
Any open spaces on your gear grid?
I don't have anything on my gear grid. Is this all my stuff?
Yes.
That I'm keeping?
Can you just put that on the gear grid?
Ah, aha. I didn't know that. I thought you just gave me a random stack.
Nope, that is yours. Sounds like you broke something.
You killed four people for that bow, Matt. Shameful.
I didn't kill him yet, technically.
And hi, E-Illusion.
E-Illusion.
It's W.
E-Illusion.
So.
Or is it Eel-Illusion?
Eel-Illusion? Maybe it's Eel-Illusion.
Get it, eel.
I get it. It's an eel. You're so punny.
I know.
I do have two open spaces.
Okay.
So
I don't know if I have anything for you, but...
So what, wait, what exactly do I get from...
Take that. Hold on. What exactly do you get from your gear?
Yes.
Okay, let me take a look and I will let you know. So you have... the full rawhide armor set.
Uh-huh.
So you're going to get two hit points to every location.
Thanks for following us, Shashi.
I'm going to set this up a little bit better.
Okay.
Because you want to connect these things, the stuff and things.
Stuff and things.
Okay, so you have a full rawhide armor set. So you get two armor to every hit location.
Okay.
And you also have the Twilight Cloak. Here you go.
So two armor.
Except the head. The head you have five.
Okay.
And so the Rawhide Armor also allows you to roll a d10 whenever you spend a survival for an activation. And it allows, and on a 6+, you regain that survival. So it gives you a 50-50 shot of regaining the survival you just spent.
And I get a lead with the max survival, correct?
That is correct.
You don't get to lead with it. At the beginning of the showdown, your
That's
survival
right.
goes to max.
Yeah.
So
if
so
you lose
happens,
during the hunt, which that actually happened to you before, you get the survival back that you spent during
so
the hunt.
So for right now it stays at 3?
You get +2 survival on depart with your gear.
Inquiring wants to know if we have any affinities that can match up with the on the sword. So if we have any left greens or right blues.
No, we do not have any.
Yeah, I don't believe we have anything that'll fit there, unfortunately.
So I have three right now. Am I moving that up to max?
Yeah, you're going to move that up to max because you get +2 and everyone gets +2 for departing. So everyone's getting +2 for sure. Can I have my...
And my brain and my insanity stays at 10.
Yeah, your insanity does not change.
Okay.
Matt, can I have my two characters?
Gave them to you already. And I need my... This is my gear here.
Can I have the other clipboard?
Yes, you can. There you go. Now, TP, you also have that sword. It's very, very good. It's all good in the hood.
Okay.
For stuff and things. I really just have waist armor and that's it.
Yep.
Jesus.
You're ranged. You don't need armor.
This is extremely ranged, though.
So, you deal with it.
It's a good thing I have sniper bow.
Put this aside, please.
That's fine.
I will be right back.
Okay.
And then...
You okay there?
Yeah.
What's up, peeps? Hey, Keganis, how you doing today? Keganis is here.
Hello, Keganis. Alright, so...
So Josh is setting up the Antelope's hit deck at the time right now.
Yeah, but you guys can go ahead and get started.
We will set up that Revlo competition in a second CAG. Page, CAG, CAG, whatever your name is.
I mean, it's up. It's,
no. The for who deals the final blow.
Oh, who deals the final
blow. Yeah, the bet there.
The betting. We want
yeah.
the betting.
So we'll get that set up in just a second unless Vetter wants to beat us to it.
I don't know if he has access to create those.
Well,
he has access to the bot to launch it, in case we forget. Who should I make who?
Who should I make who? Matt is Sabotage should definitely be the support character.
Okay. I think Matt shaves his head when I crit. We'll do that because he has Deadly.
Yeah.
So he's going to crit more.
I'm not going to shave my head, so...
All the crits. All right, so he's going to have two armored each hit location. He also has 1, 2, 3 evasion. Some natural evasion would be nice.
Keganis, we are playing Kingdom Death. We are in Lantern Year 7 right now. If you have any questions, just message it out to us, and we will...
Tweet?
Tweet, yeah. We'll do our best to explain them, answer you to the best of our knowledge.
And we are doing a giveaway tonight.
Tweet.
And Matt, I don't even know if I told you. How you would Santa Mark provided to us?
No, he doesn't pay attention to Discord.
He doesn't pay attention to Discord.
Look to your left.
The giveaways?
Yeah, we have a huge stack of games.
He told me last night. You don't pay attention.
There's a room.
Yeah, Vile Genius Games has provided us with a bunch of stuff for giveaways for you guys as well.
He's given us enough games for...
A lifetime. Not
yes,
a life.
I wish. We have one giveaway per stream until we're out of them.
Yeah.
That's pretty awesome.
So,
every single stream. We
oh, really?
Yeah.
You get a game, and you get a game!
Everybody
gets
a game!
Alright.
Oh, kids, please don't take and drive. Please.
He's totally pulled over to the side of the road. That's how it works.
Alright, Matt, you want to start getting this party started?
Let's get this party started. Okay, so I'm going to go first, and I get the first Screaming Antelope card. What is it? Oh, the Vomit Pile.
Ooh, vomit.
The survivors stomp around in the vomit and wiggle their toes around in it.
That's
TP.
Kind of fun. That's my favorite thing to do.
I was just kidding. I just wanted to see your reaction.
Okay.
The survivors find the half-digested remains of their quarry's last meal. Each survivor may scavenge, gaining +1 courage and rolling on the table. I'm going to do it.
Let me get dice.
So, everyone that decides to scavenge gets +1 courage. So, Bill Clinton is going to sift through the vomit pile. Seems like Bill Clinton would be excited
no
to do that.
Penis anymore.
We have 600.
Oh, that's right. Bill Clinton does not have a penis anymore.
Did Hillary castrate it?
I don't remember how I got castrated.
I rolled a 5, which is you find something undigested and eat it. Gain +1 survival.
Matt is Sabotage. Rolled an 8.
Rolled an 8. Okay. You find something undigested and eat it. Gain +1 survival.
I'm at max survival. Matt shaves his head when I crit. It's a 9.
Ooh. The antelope is clearly sick, vomiting up pieces of itself. Gain +1 understanding and 1 random screaming antelope resource.
Sweet.
And TP, would you like to investigate?
Sure, do it.
You're going to have Trump sift through the vomit.
I found the shank bone.
It's just like me to do it.
Vomited up
so,
the shank bone.
So cute.
Yeah, the next person in the queue, and have them roll a d10.
Loyal Sam. Hey, Loyal Sam.
Yay.
And you guys can join the queue at any time. Exclamation point, join.
Or join queue.
Or join queue if you want to type it all out.
Sometimes you just want to be, you know.
Path of least resistance.
Most resistance.
Most resistance.
Yes. So, Loyal Sam, if you could roll a d10 for us. Rolled an 8. Okay, so you find something undigested and eat it. Gain +1 survival.
Mr.
You're at max survival already.
Yes.
So,
but you do get 1 courage.
You do get a courage, so please mark yourself down a courage.
Nice.
Did you increase your max to a bold or no?
Yeah.
Okay.
It is. We're at 2.
You're at 2. So yeah. The next hunt event, that's Josh.
So Matt is Sabotage. We already did this. So it's random hunt event.
Should this still be in the deck?
Technically not, but I'm just leaving it in there and just say it's a random hunt.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's fine.
89.
89. Okay, so what do we have here? Cleaner birds. Oh, these suck.
Wonderful, wonderful birds.
Tiny, ragged birds with needle-thin beaks fly overhead. Every survivor rolls a d10. The lowest is the straggler. So if you have the thing that modifies your straggler rolls, add it now. I think you might TP.
Do I? How would I?
No, she doesn't.
No?
Because that's the bold courage.
Is it?
So if they don't have bold yet, you can't have
it. Oh, you're right. You're right. Okay,
you
I rolled
a 2.
Ooh.
Trump is the straggler.
Trump is the straggler. The birds swarm the straggler. The bird forces its way into the straggler's mouth and down their throat.
Next person roll d10.
Nope, that's it. The straggler vomits up the well-fed bird, their insides scrambled and scarred, suffer -1 permanent speed, and +1 permanent luck. You actually had +1 permanent speed already. So
yeah,
you erase that.
And
back to even,
that.
And then you get +1 luck. That's actually
so,
not terrible. Okay.
Just transferring my speed to my luck.
So you're going to be more easy for you to crit,
okay.
But you don't hit as many times.
You're good, Newt. You're fine.
It's actually kind of a fun one if you get with it, if you get it on someone who is plus luck, and they don't care about their speed. It's like, oh, I have
I crit
plus
every
luck.
Single time.
I crit every single time.
Yeah.
We've had it happen to the same person like 2 or 3 times.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, I have +3 luck.
Alpha Decay confirms I prefer luck over speed any day.
Yeah. All right.
Josh,
so
your next one. This is migration. Some unforeseen force has set off a massive migration. Nothing remains but uprooted acanthus plants and shattered ground ruined by hooves. Move these screaming antelope 3 spaces away from the survivors on the hunt board. That's terrible. Okay, so TP, it is now your turn.
Okay.
Dead warrior. Do we have pictographs?
Nope.
Okay, so roll D100, please.
Okay.
D100. Pay attention.
Shattered
attack D100. So Trump, one of those typical speeches, vomits out a bird and feels lucky. That is correct, Valk. That's just that we keep getting this one, and we can't do it because we don't have friggin' pictographs.
One day we might.
7 out of 100.
Really?
Yes.
Okay. That's a weird roll.
I mean, it's statistically.
The same as any other.
Mm-hmm.
A hungry ground. The ground suddenly splits and a gaping stone mouth attempts to devour the event revealer hole. Roll on the table below.
Oh.
So roll again.
Another d10 rolled.
Okay. Oh, VRX. If you could roll a d10, it's !! Roll d10.
Oh, goodness. This is a good one.
Alpha Decay with Q, but
oh, goodness. You
what
got
rolled?
2.
Okay.
The event revealer scrambles, but their legs are caught in the terrible maw. Suffer 2 damage to your legs.
Okay.
Take care of your leg armor.
You got really lucky, because a 1 would have been
dead. I'm surprised a 2 isn't dead, honestly.
Yeah, I am, too. I think it's just because it's an early entry in
yeah.
there.
Thanks for helping, RX.
The RX. Yay, I'm helping.
The prescription.
The prescription. Okay, so
your turn.
Random on event.
35.
What does 35 give us? Broken lantern oven. The survivors come across the shattered ruins of a small settlement. Scattered corpses dot the ruins, disintegrating at the merest touch. An extinguished lantern oven stands intact at the center of the settlement. If any survivor has 3+ understanding.
Nope.
The event revealer harvests a broken lantern basic resource from the remains. So I get a broken lantern resource. If they
no
already
survivor,
have this innovation.
No, if no survivor has 3+ understanding.
Oh. The site throws the survivors into a fit of rage and they smash the lantern oven. We all gain +1 insanity.
Yay!
So we don't understand the lantern oven that we have.
We, even though we have it, we're all just idiots.
Well, I mean, it works out in our favor, right?
No.
No?
What's your insanity?
3.
Okay, never mind. Okay, so overwhelming darkness.
Oh, yay! Overwhelming darkness.
Oh, goodness. So, TP, we're going to need someone to roll a d10 for you.
D10. Let's do this again. Trump smash puny oven.
Yeah.
Loyal Sim, you can roll a d10 for
okay,
us.
Okay, so Josh, how about you go first?
Yeah, and we're going
are you insane?
Doomed.
Are you doomed or are you brave?
Doomed.
Doomed. I am doomed as well. We're all insane?
She's
3 insanity.
3. I only have 1.
Oh, so you're... Oh, I'm sorry. You're doomed.
I'm doomed.
Duh.
Five.
Loyalty rolled a 10.
Oh, we'll get there in 1 second. So the Path of the Doomed, an unseen monster attacks, suffer event damage equal to the quarry's level to 3 random hit locations. Josh takes 1 damage to his head, his body, and his foot. And that's for who?
That's for Sabotage.
And roll for your next one, please, Josh.
He's also doomed. 7.
Disoriented, gain -1 evasion token.
Whatever.
And now my turn. I am insane. Oh. You envision a strange fruit that pulses with your heartbeat. You smash it. Spend all your survival or die. I have no survival now.
But my survival.
Yeah.
And
you rolled a 10 TP?
I'm the insane.
Yes.
Okay, so hysterical, you suffer the frenzy brain trauma. Which is actually very good.
So you get +1 strength.
And +1 speed.
+1 speed. You cannot use survival, though.
Yeah, that's the problem. You can't use
any fighting arts. So we can't get
Red
Fist.
We don't get Red Fist.
You get +1 strength and what?
I'm giving you tokens right now.
Oh, plus...
And shit.
Yep.
Wait, so what happens?
You get +1 speed and +1 strength.
Okay, but...
Well, shit. You can't
Wait,
use...
Wait, is it the beginning of the showdown or the beginning of the...
Can you get the card, Josh?
Yeah,
I believe it's at the beginning of the showdown.
Alpha says that's okay,
yeah,
that there's in a campus ahead.
That sucks, though, because you have the Red Fist Fighting Art, so when the showdown begins, we would normally all gain +1 strength token. However, when you're frenzied, you don't get to use your fighting arts.
So, it's showdown time.
Showdown time, yay, we're fighting the Screaming Antelope! Are you on board cam, TK?
I am not, sorry.
So not now, now's the time to do it, that's fine. Okay, so we start out on either board edge, and we need 3 Acanthus Plant cards, and 2 randoms. On the edges.
So all the Acanthus. So 3 cards, or...?
We need 3 Acanthus cards and 2 randoms.
Acanthus, Acanthus. Acanthus.
Ecoy says you can get tokens before a showdown starts. Ecoy, we're having the issue here of...
She's frenzied now.
She's frenzied now, so you're technically not allowed to use fighting arts, and Red Fist says when the showdown starts, we all get +1 strength token. So
Ooh.
Technically we wouldn't be able to...
Wait, what caused the brain trauma roll?
No brain trauma roll. It was the overwhelming darkness. She rolled a 10 on the Path of the Insane, which gives you frenzy. Well, that's good. We got a giant stone face.
Yeah, so you could, like, shoot across the board.
Yeah. And especially if I go sniper. I can just be like,
plus 2 accuracy,
there.
Plus 2 range.
Yeah, well, yeah. Plus, here I can do up to 9 range, so I'd have 11 range. Josh?
Yep.
That's silly. Yeah, you don't get the benefits of Red Fist in that case. That's sad. So this is set up at least 5 spaces away from all board edges. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay.
Oh yeah, I forgot. Hey guys, I got your tickets covered.
Oh, you did?
Oh.
Thank you.
Tickets
so,
for this weekend?
Yeah.
Oh, so
fantastic.
I don't know if that means... What you said, where we buy 2...
I think that means we're fully covered. From what that sounded like, which is awesome.
Also, just want to clarify. In which case, I'm buying a drink on Saturday.
Woo! What about me? You buy me a drink?
No, fuck you.
Buy yourself a soap. We gotta put these
in. Oh, you're awesome!
Oh, Kadra, please set up... I want you to set up the Rebel competition. Who's gonna get the final blow?
Ah, yes.
Sorry, Kadra, we'll get that up now.
Matt, put those... And this is...
So essentially, what, tickets were like $35 each or something? That means we basically got a free table. Who paid for the tickets got a free table.
Basically.
Buy you a drink.
Put that over by us. It has to go board edge.
No, it doesn't.
Yes.
Here.
No, this is the
bridge. Oh, sorry.
Board edge, so it'll go right next to one of us.
So
so I can...
But it's going to be on business cards. Technically, Matt's buying you a third of the drink.
There you go.
Dollar well drinks.
So, now...
I hope you like chia grass.
Okay, so we've got Donald Trump.
Donald Trump. Bill Clinton.
Bill.
Matt is sabotage. And Matt shakes his head when I crit. I need to put a character limit on names.
Yeah. Yeah, whatever.
I'm
not done. Okay, so I think we're ready to begin.
And I will have Mana Sabotage start as Monster Controller.
So, first quick stats on the Screaming Antelope. It has a movement of 6 and a toughness of 8.
Alright.
And how many AI cards does it start with? I believe 10?
10.
So,
so 11
it has 11 health to start out.
Alright. First card.
Stomp and Snort, random survivor in range.
No one's in range.
No target, graze. Monster full moves to the closest acanthus plant and ends its turn. If the monster is on or adjacent to an acanthus plant, heal one wound.
Right, so he's going to eat.
Boom. Nom 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 nom.
So it's one less plant for us to collect.
I guess we don't have any clubs or shields, right?
We have one shield.
We have one shield.
We have the knuckle shield. So we're not totally in the dark here. It's been a really long time since we fought.
Yeah, Clubs and Shield get the plus strength bonuses.
Yeah.
But I think we're okay, because I have the King Spear 2 on my shield guy, and that's pretty high strength.
And I have the friggin' Sniper Bow.
Yeah.
I think we're okay.
And you have 2 arrows.
I do have 2 arrows. Okay, so I'm going to go first. I'm going to run up here and climb on top of Giant Stone Face.
You take your turn.
No, because I don't have any survival.
You
have
no survival, so you can't do anything.
Shit, okay.
Alright.
Why are you laughing?
I don't need survival.
I lost it all by my roll of a 1 on the Path of the Insane table.
So with, so I'm going to say...
Newt says, is that how the plants are set up? I thought they were supposed to be in 6 spaces apart organized in pairs.
Normally, yes. However, in the, it's Screaming Antelope showdown here. It just says place them in the green area.
Yeah, so you can place them wherever you want in the green area. It doesn't say... You ignore the rules of the card.
Yeah. So. Yeah, it sounds like the rest of us, Kadge.
So I'm going to have Matt choose his Heavenly Crypt, which is the yellow one. Collect
okay.
that Debris.
Debris.
Debris. And you rolled a 1.
What does that mean?
Entangled, you are knocked down. So, yeah. And that goes off
roll.
The board. So, he goes nowhere. I will have... Matt is Sabotage.
Which is the blue.
Which is the blue. Far away from the rest, am I?
You are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 spaces away from the monster. So, TP...
I'm gonna...
Newt says, I guess I read that wrong. I fought the antelope, like, 4 times that way.
Oh.
Are you guys sure?
Alpha Decay yeah. said that we were correct.
Okay. Alright.
I forgot to
I
do something.
I don't believe them until someone confirms.
What did you forget to do?
Tactics card.
Oh, tactics card.
Because I have the Flower Badge. Flower Knight Badge.
Very cool.
So, what tactics card do we have for this fight?
Lance Formation. So, while the survivors are standing in this formation... the survivor in the magenta position gains +2 speed, +2 strength. So if we are in a formation where there's one survivor in front and 3 survivors in a row behind them, with that one survivor in the front centered, then they get +2 speed, +2 strength, which is phenomenal.
Yeah, but probably not going to happen. So.
Yeah, probably not going to happen.
At least not in this fight. I think I'm going to dash, and then move, and then...
Smack it?
It's not good.
Okay, so you are going.
So let me see if I use my survival.
4, 5.
I do use my survival.
1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, we're going to move you there.
And then I'm going to hit it with my shield.
Okay. Human centipede formation, go.
Yeah, I'm going to hit it with the shield.
2, 6, 7.
For those of you who are just
that's
joining
one
in,
hit.
We are giving away a sci-fi
Twilight,
Twilight Knight
yeah.
promo figure.
So pay attention.
Boots.
Pay attention to Revlo. You could join up and try and win it yourself.
What's
so
his
Josh
toughness?
Is attacking the relentless, restless rump. He has a toughness of 8.
That's not enough.
Not a hit. This is a reflex. Turn the monster to face away from the attacker and full move in a straight line.
quick here. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right.
Okay, so Twitch, it's your turn. You can't actually reach the monster or get anywhere close to it. And I'm assuming you guys just want to get closer so you can move your full movement 5 spaces closer to the monster.
That's fine, and that's including our lack of speed.
What's your speed at?
No. Speed is your attack.
Oh.
Your attack.
Movement is your movement. Yeah.
Okay.
No, yeah, it's a little, if you don't remember that, it's like, that's one that catches me off guard every once in a while. Okay, so it is now the monster's turn.
Yep.
So, John? Josh?
John.
John.
I'm John now?
Yes.
Alright, so...
Tell him at Gen Con that he wanted to be one of those fans. Wait, what?
Tell.
That he should put the human centipede in the game.
Ah, yes.
So, Ram.
So, Ram, furthest threat in range.
There's only one threat in range.
Okay.
Mana sabotage.
Okay, so speed of 1, accuracy of 2 plus for 1 damage.
Okay, so 1 die.
And plus 1 damage to this attack for every space the monster moved to get to the target. Plus 6 damage.
Alright, I have 3 evasion.
It's an accuracy of 2 plus, so it's an accuracy of 5 plus.
That's a 10.
That's a 10. So do you want to...
I'm not taking that. Screw that. I still use my survival.
Use your survival, but Josh does dodge the attack. Thankfully. Josh plus shave equals John.
Who said that?
That was Alex and Sam.
Alright, so Antelope tried to beat the shit out of me. I said, fuck
he
God.
Tried to ram you.
He did try to ram me. I'm thinking I might want to use my spear. So I get back up.
Okay, so where are you going, Josh?
I think Twitch should go first.
Okay, so Twitch.
Unless you want to shoot it with one of your arrows.
Yes, let me try and shoot it with the clawhead arrow.
The clawhead?
Yeah.
Okay,
so I'm going to shoot it with the clawhead arrow. This is a speed of 1, accuracy of 6 plus, but I'm on the face.
So it's a...
And it gives me plus 2 accuracy,
yes.
And plus 2 range, correct?
Yes.
Okay, so accuracy of 4 plus to hit. Wouldn't have got it without the face. And I'm attacking the restless back. So this is if you hit with a shield or club, you get plus 2 luck. So that's plus luck, not strength.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm probably just crazy in this thought, but I swear Josh shaved looks like a lot like Day 9.
I don't know what Day 9 is. Okay, so this is a strength of 6. And he's got 8 toughness, so I need to roll 2 plus. I rolled a 2. That's a hit. He takes 1 wound.
Takes 1 wound.
And most importantly...
Minus 1 evasion.
Minus 1 evasion for the monster. TP, what are
minus
you doing? You look really confused.
I'm just looking at his face. It's like, I actually like the 5 o'clock shadow thing going on. I think, like, that's ideal. So, thank you.
It's a little bit more than 5 o'clock shadow.
It's a hearty stubble.
It's a hearty stubble. Dana is a lovely streamer of
Vidya.
Vidya.
Okay,
so that was my turn. So, Twitch proxy... I think it's a good time for you guys to run up and smash it with your sword.
I love smashing
it
with my sword.
Ew. So you get right up in the monster's face. Unfortunately, you can't hit the butt, but it's time to attack. So I need you to roll 3 d10s.
That's what they're...
Now, imagine if I could get it to get a haircut.
3 d10s.
Okay, so that's Q3.
And do you have any plus accuracy on your sheet, TP?
You do not.
So it's an accuracy of 5 plus, which means you actually need a 4 plus to hit because of the minus evasion that I just gave the monster.
Alright, so KJ rolled Newton, the prescription, the RX roll. Okay, we got 2 sevens.
2 sevens, so that's 2 hits. We need a third.
Oh, the RX, I just pulled 3 different names, so all you have to do is exclamation point roll d10.
Roll d10.
Just
one
d10. Kind of gives everyone a chance to do it more often as opposed to one person rolling.
Right.
Three.
So, Cage, you guys were actually plus 1 speed, then you got the thing give you minus 1 speed, so you were back at neutral with the weapon, and then you got frenzied and got a plus 1 speed again.
And we get a 5.
So that's 3 hits.
Awesome.
So you're attacking the giant teeth, the restless tiny hands, and the delicate inverted knee.
So
the failure card lasts because that's the only one with a negative reaction to it.
Okay.
So we need 3 more d10s to be rolled.
Okay.
And what order that they have, whatever order we get them in as, we'll play them as.
Okay, Loyal Sim, Alex and Sam, and Cage. Cage rolled a 6.
That is more than enough to wound, so that's a wound.
Okay. Tiny hand. Oh,
yeah.
I got a 7 from Alex and Sam.
That is another wound.
Wow, we're doing well. And a 6.
That is another wound.
Wow, we got
3 wounds.
3 wounds. Unfortunately, you can't spend a survival to attack again because you are frenzied.
Okay.
But you can't really argue with the results of that.
I mean, that was pretty successful.
Yeah. So,
right.
Josh, it's now your turn.
Let's move. I don't want to do this.
You can certainly try.
How far away if I move 5 spaces forward? How far would I be?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You would then be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 spaces away from the antelope.
So I could throw my bone darts at it.
Yes, you could.
Do I want to throw the bone darts first or attack with my shield again?
Inquiring Newt says the antelope is such a pushover, I'd prefer it over the lion. I actually think that the lion's a little easier until you get to level 3. The lion gets really ridiculous then. But at the same time, Beast of Sorrow is such a great farmable lion.
Yes.
It's fantastic.
Alright, I'm gonna not go to the butt.
He's gonna go diagonally because he's got the King's Spear.
Oh, no.
No?
I want to hit my shield.
Oh.
I'm worried about his reaction to turning around and running.
I think you're fine.
Shield has plus luck on certain locations.
Yes. Yeah, we got
so I'm gonna hit with the shield again.
So
more for the luck.
The speed and what do you need to hit?
I needed a 5 plus to hit.
So you got 2 hits.
I got 2 hits.
And you are attacking the Ferocious Spasm and the Restless Eye. This is a first strike one. So first strike, the Screaming Antelope's massive eyes glisten with human-like fear. If the attacker is insane, are you insane?
No, I'm not.
Okay, so never mind.
All right.
Otherwise, you do suffer brain damage.
All right, so I lose my 1 insanity.
And now you roll 2 wound. And what's your strength? Oh, you crit.
I crit.
The monster's vision is devastated. It gains -1 evasion token. So now it is even easier to hit. It's got -2 evasion. So whatever your weapon says you need to hit, subtract 2 from that.
Okay.
All right.
And then the Ferocious Spasm. This is a reflex. So the Screaming Antelope frantically attacks everything around it.
So it's going to attack the two of us standing.
Unless you crit it.
Nope.
No? Oh,
there's
no
crit.
Crit, yeah.
Location on there, so... It's a 2, that's not going to wound.
Okay, so Zone of Death.
So basic
one
attack.
One at a time, target each of the survivors in the Zone of Death and perform a basic action. So target Twitch first.
Yeah, target Twitch first, which is
four
a speed of 2.
Detective.
They have +1 evasion.
Correct.
Because of their gear.
So,
so
one,
that's
hit.
One hit.
One
you
hit.
Can't spend survival to dodge, so you have
no, they
to
can't.
Take it.
Okay,
no,
so
they can't.
Gonna...
They're not the attacking survivor.
They're frenzied.
Frenzied.
Oh, they're frenzied, so yeah, forgot about that.
Okay, so we are going to... The person that I'm going to pull up on the queue needs to roll an hit location. It's exclamation point roll HL. Dead Pickle, you can... Dead Pickle, you can enter to win that sci-fi Twilight Night at any time. You get a free ticket. It's exclamation point ticket space 1.
To redeem one
to
ticket.
To redeem one free ticket.
Yes.
You can also check your points at any time. Exclamation point points. And 25 points can... add up to an additional ticket.
And you get 1 point for every minute that you're watching us.
Yeah, so... And then I'm going to roll against...
So, Newt, if you
me,
can roll an HL.
That's 2 hits.
Feet.
So you get
2 to 1
damage to your feet.
Okay, feet.
Ooh, well, you got 2 damage previously to that, so you should have a light wound there on your feet.
And I got a light wound on my chest, or my body.
Okay.
And that's the end of that turn. And now I am going to darsh...
Darsh.
Forward with Matt.
His sabotage?
No, every time I crit.
Ew, cage.
Okay.
And then I'm going to throw one of my bone darts.
Okay. You're going to hit his
I like onions.
Little one,
roll
so that's
one.
A failure.
It's a failure. All right.
It is now the monster's turn.
Which is monster
Which
control.
You are monster controller.
And they're going to do slam.
Slam. The closest knockdown survivor, the furthest threat in field of view in range. 1, 2. So that's... That's going to be you.
Is it? Or we're both the same range.
I'd rather attack you.
That's fine. They're going to get trampled, though.
No.
Yeah, because he... Oh.
No, he can go forward one. He can go that direction one first.
No, this is quicker path. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 versus 1, 2, 3, 4.
It's
oh,
the same amount.
Fine. Okay.
I know how to count.
All right, that's fine.
And it's going to do a speed of 1, accuracy of 2 plus.
So someone roll a d10. Twitch?
D10?
Because you are the monster. Angry Twitch monster.
So the RX, if you could please...
The prescription. So we need one d10 to be rolled. And what's your evasion, Josh?
None.
That makes the Q list.
Hmm?
Listed. Oh,
two.
In the next quarter.
Oh, that stinks. You don't have any evasion?
No evasion.
So you take one damage. It's really not that bad of an attack.
Move down, Matt. Whatever screws you over most is the way it happens.
That's pretty much accurate.
Oh, light hit.
If Matt can count wild sabotage.
And we're talking about.
All right. So it's our turn.
All right.
That is true.
What's your other arrow do?
Getting there. My other arrow is the Vespertine arrow. It provides deadly 4.
It's a good crit.
Yeah, it's a great crit. Archive this after the use. If the attack misses, place a flower patch. So it's a crit card. For sure.
Okay, so that's just an auto, like, basically auto crit kind
of thing. Yeah, so if you actually want to use your support character to... Oh no, I have the cat eye circlet.
Yes, I gave you the cat eye circlet.
Well, that stinks.
Valkmil says, Matt, Twitch Panda, I'm about to warn you, your characters may be doomed. You're both red shirts on the stream
right now. Technically, she's a red dress.
I think it counts.
Does it count?
And I know the reference.
What's the reference?
Star Trek.
Mm-hmm. Star Wars.
No.
I'm just trying to trip you up here.
My dad was a Trekkie.
Oh, that's right. I forgot.
Ooh, that would be interesting.
What's that?
If you do the formation. If I dash.
It would be really hard for me to get there.
Yeah, no, no. If he moves over one, I move here, and then Twitch goes there, and then they just beat the shit out of it.
Gabe said the only solution is to take them off, and Dogfield says you Matt's titties.
That is true. You could do that.
That is true.
No, I'm okay. Let's do it.
All right, I'm going to attack first with every time I crit.
Okay.
Speed of 2, 4 plus hits.
One hit.
One hit.
And you're attacking the furry tail.
You
strike
has,
the magnificent bushy tail.
This has, he has 4 strength. Oh, I have minus 1 evasion on my other character too, so he's definitely in the hit.
He has minus 2 evasion.
Yeah. So that doesn't matter.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So I have 4 strength, so I need 4 plus.
Okay.
8.
Do you have any luck?
Just though
okay.
Deadly.
So
enough.
You wound.
So I wound.
Valkyrie says, you know what's weird? Ever since Josh shaved his beard, he stopped mumbling.
I'm gonna move here.
Thanks for joining the Q side.
We moved the microphone closer to Josh as well.
Yeah, I have the mic closer. Matt, you want to go?
Yes, I'm going to go now, and I'm going to use the Vespertine bow.
Just the bow?
Yeah, the arrow, I'm sorry. The Vespertine
arrow. Just flip over the arrow you did use, just so you know you used it.
So this is a speed of 2, accuracy of 6 plus.
So it's 4. 2 plus.
Yeah.
Josh's face parasite was eating his words. I think that's an accurate description.
Let's do it.
So I'm attacking the giant tongue and the gnarled horns. I'm going to attempt this one first, and then this one.
So what's the strength on your arrow?
0, actually. It is 0 strength.
Okay.
So it's actually, I crit before I wound.
Yep.
So I crit on a 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 50%.
Yeah.
7, that's a crit. Gain 1 screaming antelope resource.
You get a large flat tooth, and someone gets plus 1 insanity, our choice.
I think you are at 0 for one of your characters.
I am, but it wouldn't be bad for Trump to start getting some more, because once he gets 3 understanding, he can't use that cloak anymore.
That's true. So, TP, if you want to give Trump plus 1 insanity, please.
Trump plus 1 insanity, we are...
Yeah, he's not in that... Worry limit yet of...
Yeah, and I'm going to attack the gnarled horns now. That's another crit. Gain 1 screaming antelope resource. Persistent injury, crushed crown. Blood pours from the ruined crown. This affects some AI cards.
Alright.
I'm farming this.
He only has a couple hits left.
Do you want to get into the formation and have Twitch proxy go to Killing Blow?
That is the plan.
Okay.
So I'm going to...
Killing Blow already.
Yeah.
I'm going to dash...
You use your survival.
I use my survival. Right.
So you go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 spaces.
And then I am going to attack with the spear.
Because you can. Because
I can have reach.
Yeah, you got the reach.
So 4 plus hits.
That's 2 hits.
Two hits.
You know what's going to happen, right? T TP's going to get the tarp card.
Possibly.
So you're attacking the restless shoulder and the restless muzzle. So I'm going to do the restless muzzle first. It's got no reaction.
I have 3 strength, so I need 5 plus.
That is an 8. Do you have any plus luck?
No.
Okay, so that is a wound. Oh, I'm sorry. Was that attack with a shield or club?
No.
Alex and Sam said, oh, you named the characters Trump, etc. I didn't vote for the killing blow because I thought it was a political plot. Very dark with the characters that we named.
No luck.
It's voted on and suggested completely by Twitch, so...
Okay, so, unfortunately, we're going to not be able to do the formation. So, your blow clips the screaming antelope shoulder, and it jumps back. Turn to face the attacker. Then, without turning, move the monster one space directly away from the attacker. Cancel all hits now out of range.
Wait, he goes here?
Yes.
And then he...
That's it.
That's okay. I wouldn't want them to go in formation anyway.
Because of the speed.
It just...
He has no AI cards left.
No AI cards left.
So, it's just proxy. You get to go and punch it in the butt for the killing blow.
We could do one thing.
Check the hit location.
What?
No.
I want to kill it by punching in the butt.
Oh, harvest acanthus.
We can harvest the acanthus plants pretty easily, and he's not really going to do much.
Actually, yeah, that's probably the better thing. It's better for us to get acanthus. He's right.
And he's not even going to go after us. He's going to try to heal himself.
Okay.
So it's going to be a battle of us. So he'll get some AI cards back?
Yeah. But I'll take it away.
Shashi, don't apologize. Everyone's new at one point or the other.
Exactly.
We're happy to help.
Yep.
So do you want to do that TP? Do you want to harvest the acanthus?
Or do they want to go for the killing blow? We're asking Twitch.
Yeah, this is...
Harvest the acanthus?
Harvest the acanthus or go for the killing blow?
Okay, so here's the thing. They're going to be a little biased based on what they voted for.
Yeah, that's exactly true.
We'll still let you guys smash it.
We'll go for the...
Yeah, it's just... We take a turn.
So are we the last character to go before the... Turn?
Yeah.
Yes.
So it'll be us, Antelope, and then us again.
Correct.
Okay. Do it. Do it.
Let's farm. Farm.
Oh, sorry.
Acanthus.
So
yeah. Right, so
have someone roll a D10, and you're going to try to grab the first acanthus plant here.
Why'd you move him?
I moved him there because he's
going
to eat this, and then we can get over here.
Yeah. So Twitch Proxy will be the next person in the queue, and you're going to roll to see if you pick up the acanthus plant or not. Killing butt punch is my vote from
Why
Josh. How do you say his name?
Always at the top. There's something wrong with your queue.
How do you say that guy's name?
I can't see my phone.
Your favorite one?
No, I can't see.
Kerfunkel. Josh is really salty right now.
Josh is really salty.
Because you're like...
Great. Why is it always Cage? I think there's something wrong with the queue.
No, there's nothing wrong. You find nothing in our country's brain.
Good job, Cage.
Alright.
So it's a monster's turn.
You're monster control.
Okay. And he's going to eat a canthus.
Yeah. He's going to heal them.
He eats one, right?
Yeah, so the one he's on.
Okay, and he regains one AI card.
Yeah. It's okay.
That's it. So now it's our turn again. So Josh, do you want to go and farm?
Totally always at the top. You always are. You're always rolling.
I'm going to grab one.
Seven.
That's what she said.
I get one survival.
And
I'm going to... No, you need A+. I don't spend my
survival,
to surge, so I actually have 2.
Wait, I thought
it was
collecting
the other acanthus.
I'm collecting the acanthus. And then I'm going to roll and try to get the other one.
Peter.
6.
That's another survival.
Okay,
so do you want to try and get it with your other character?
Yeah, so I'm going to dash over there with that.
One hit in the butt.
8. I think that's you get the acanthus.
Yes, I finally got it. So we got one acanthus, so that's good.
Yeah. So now, to Twitch Proxy, it is your turn. So we need you to roll 3d10s.
And
the monster's got 2 health left, so you only need to wound on 2 of the hits. So the next 3 people.
So Mr. Purple, Loyal Sam, and Alex and Sam.
You read that backwards.
Yes, it is.
Alex and Sam rolled an 8, so that's 1 hit.
Trap card!
No!
Should have checked.
Yeah, the screaming antelope panics, its undermouth unleashing an inhuman wail. It bucks wildly and leaps into the air. Twitch Proxy, you are now doomed. All survivors adjacent to the monster suffer 2 brain damage and knock back 5 and are knocked down.
So my antenna is going from 4 to 2.
Check my box.
You're down. The monster lands on its belly and begins to slide on its teeth. Turn the monster directly away from the attacker and full move forward in a straight line.
He's over there.
I'm sorry, but...
Oops. No! It's all your fault.
It's Vespertine bow time.
Rule number three.
It's always Josh's fault.
Yes, always Josh.
Doom! Inquire your left cheek! Okay, so I'm going to shoot it with the Vespertine bow. It is an accuracy of 6+, which is really a 2+, because I'm on the stone face and he's got -2 evasion.
Yes.
Yeah. Did you roll a 1?
And a 2, but that's 2 hits. I'm attacking the restless muzzle and the restless shoulder, so I'm going to do the restless muzzle first. This bow has a strength of 6, which means I need to roll a 2+.
Yes.
And I have...
Deadly
on it.
Okay. So 9+ crits?
Yeah, 9+ crits. That's a wound.
Is that a wound?
Yeah, 6.
Yeah, it is a wound. Alright, so we get rid of that IR card again. AI card again.
And another 2! I wounded it, and it's dead! I killed the screaming antelope. Yay!
Mad is sabotage.
No. Bill Clinton.
Sabotage.
No, Bill Clinton.
You're sabotage.
Bill Clinton. So Bill Clinton dealt the killing blow.
And you want to read off what we got?
We got a pelt, the beast steak, the shank bone,
ooh,
and the pelt.
So one person voted for Bill Clinton with a minimum of 10, and they are going to get all the points.
Who was it?
Let's pick the winner. It is going to be the RX.
Ah, the RX.
Get 10 points and won 215. That is enough.
Yeah,
eight tickets.
The RX slide on its teeth. That is horrifying. Yeah, that is horrifying. Actually, if you can do a close up of the minifigure and show the RX its underbelly, it's got a mouth on its underbelly that has all of these terrible teeth, and that's how it's actually it eats people through its tummy belly.
You want to read the other resources we got?
We also got a monster bone, a monster organ, a monster hide, and a broken lantern.
Lots of resources.
And when the monster is defeated, any survivor with 20+ insanity?
Nope.
Okay, we're okay then.
Everyone get a Hun XP?
Everyone gains +1 Hun XP, and that means Bill Clinton has aged up.
So
and
1 second, guys. Shoshi, you get 1 free ticket. You can redeem at any time! !Ticket space 1. You get 1 point per minute that you're in here. You can check your points at any time! !Points. And 25 points add up to an additional ticket. You can also gamble your points if you want to.
If you're an addict.
Like Cage.
Can you... Hunt XP? And weapon proficiency for you.
And weapon proficiency. Okay.
6.
Ooh.
+1 permanent strength. Very good.
Not bad.
I got that. Oh, Bill Clinton's going to be the bow guy. So I'm
he's
going to
shoot a bow because he can't shoot his thing off anymore.
He can't shoot off his load anymore.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
Okay. And did you age up? I don't think. What's Donald up?
What is your Hunt XP at?
3.
Okay.
Okay. So you got a few more until you age up. And your weapon proficiency is at what?
1 now.
1.
That was their first fight with...
And because that one went so quick, would you be opposed to doing another...
I would be okay with that.
Okay. So we're going to get back to town.
So let's take care of this.
It's a
we're going to take care of
busy
these.
Year.
Oh, is it really?
Yes.
Okay. So we'll see how this goes. If we have enough time, we're going to get another quarry hunt next.
Yeah.
So if you guys want to shout out in chat which quarry monster you'd like to fight, we're going to see if we can do that one.
Black Storms. So let's.
Okay.
Let's go through this quickly.
Okay. Hurry it up, Josh.
All right. So we are coming back to the settlement.
And put the cap on.
All right,
then. Okay.
What?
No.
Can I have the rivalry card?
You can have the rivalry card. Yeah, Alpha Decay. I think Gorm. If the Phoenix level.
Phoenix level 3.
No.
The
so option. Alex and Sam, the options we have right now are Lion, Gorm, Screaming Antelope. I think that's it, right?
And Phoenix.
And Flower Knight.
And Flower Knight. And there's more coming up in
that's right.
Just
we,
a minute.
We just get Stranger in the Dark.
D10.
I don't remember this one.
This is the guy we had, Stranger, who was awesome and was sneaky. And
oh,
then
he
disappeared
fell
in the hut.
Nudie, you can roll a.
Yeah, we were so sad and we cried.
Yeah, this is a good one.
Five.
5? Okay.
Not bad.
The stranger is dressed in black in a black ragged cloak that obscures its form. A myriad of strange lanterns hang from chains wrapped around its body. The stranger speaks in a dark, raspy tone. I am the lamplighter. Give me your light. Each player nominates a different survivor to bring him a lantern and rolls a d10. So we each have to nominate a survivor.
Okay.
Do we nominate 4 survivors or just 3?
It says each
player so I guess
nominates
3?
A different survivor. Yes, we're going to nominate 3.
Okay.
So, TP, you choose a survivor. I'm going to choose a survivor. Josh is going to choose a survivor.
Who are you choosing? Is Bill going to go?
I'm cheating.
Cheater.
No. I'm going to choose Matt of Sabotage.
Newt wants to nominate Bill Clinton.
Oh, damn it. No, not Bill.
Cheater.
I'd rather nominate someone that doesn't really matter.
Yeah, Narflake.
Narflake, a.k.a. Kerfunkel.
Kerfunkel.
We tease Josh off-stream about his pronunciation of your name every fucking day.
I'm going to nominate the Not-So-Slender Man.
The Not-So-Slender Man. Okay, so we each have to roll...
Are you nominating Matt?
Hmm?
It's called that.
Yeah.
Each player nominates a different survivor to bring him a lantern and roll. So we each have to roll a d10.
Okay.
Okay.
A 9.
BRX, you can roll a d10 for us.
Oh.
Exclamation point, roll d10.
So this actually happens for each one of the survivors that we nominated.
Okay.
So Bill Clinton, I'm going to wait till we all roll, but that's... Thank you.
Yeah. For the not so, this is for the Not-So-Slender.
Oh. No, it's... Oh, yeah, so...
I nominated Not So Slender Man. You nominated
Matt of Sabotage.
Matt of Sabotage, and they nominated Bill Clinton.
Of course, they're gonna get something.
7.
Oh.
So
okay.
So it is.
It's for everyone. Everyone gets the same exact thing. This is actually very good. The stranger returns the lantern to the survivors, glowing with a beautiful orange light that adds sparkle to their eyes. They each gain +1 courage and +1 strength.
Okay, so and this is not the character you're playing, this is the character you nominated.
Correct, this is the character you
so
nominated.
So Not So Slender Man and Sabotage?
Yes. Well, whoever Matt nominated.
Matt is Sabotage. And then I got Bill Clinton here. So Bill Clinton has 2 permanent strength now.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Very cool.
Very, very cool.
Alright, so that was that.
One climb then.
No, not that. Can you grab the Dung Beetle book, please?
Yes, I can.
No, you can certainly try.
Certainly try.
Now, by switching over to this.
Can you start putting a poll up, please?
Okay, let's see this. Hang on. Poll new.
Which quarry to fight next? Quarry.
And what are those?
White Lion.
You don't have to whisper. White Lion.
Thank you.
Gorm.
Screaming Antelope.
Hang on. I'm just saying Antelope.
Flower
Phoenix.
Knight. Flower Knight.
And Dung Beetle Knight.
And?
How fast do you think I can type?
Sounds like you're going pretty good. And finally?
Sunstalker and Dragon King.
Oh my god.
Yes.
So I don't think we're getting... I don't know if we're going to be able to get through that if we get all these stories going.
Okay, so let's see. Hang on. So the option so far... So the option... Oops. I just... Ah, fudge. Hang on.
This is going to be true.
I just lost it.
What's
I forgot that,
that
if you hit up, it kind of deletes what you wrote. Okay, so... I thought we weren't doing all the expansion packs.
We're not.
We're not doing all the nemesis encounters.
This is the quarry.
Yeah, so we're just doing quarries.
So it's Gorm, White Lion. Don't tell me. Dung Beetle. Flower Knight. Phoenix. Don't tell me. No.
Antelope.
Antelope.
Sunstalker.
Sunstalker.
Dragon King.
Dragon. There's something else. What?
That's
Lion
it.
Something?
No, that's it.
Phoenix, Flower Knight.
Not the Lion Knight,
right? Not the Lion Knight.
Yeah, that's
Gorm,
it.
Gorm, White Lion, Dung Beetle, Flower Knight, Phoenix, Antelope, Sunstalker, Dragon King.
I think that's it, yeah.
Okay, so you guys vote for that while we read the story. So now we have the rumbling in the dark. I need a female survivor to be nominated. Just a reminder, Donald Trump is female. I'm assuming you guys want to nominate Donald Trump, but just shout it out in chat.
We can't play this on the ground.
A low, constant rumble woke a woman sleeping on the ground. She quietly shifted her bedding aside and lowered her ear to the ground. Something strange was happening out in the darkness. In a breathless moment, the woman's wonder overcame her fear, and she set out to find the source of the tremors underfoot. Yeah. Trump.
All right. So, you want the first thing.
So, Trump gains plus one permanent strength.
Okay.
He was locked out of the party.
The woman followed her feet, or Donald Trump followed her feet. This is Trump, right?
Yeah.
Feeling her way toward the rumble until it became a quake. Ahead, she saw a peculiar figure struggling to push a massive sphere up a hill. The object appeared quite heavy, and the creature faltered often, losing ground. Each time it did, it redoubled its efforts and rolled the massive weight back up the hill, shaking the ground anew. At first glance, the struggle appeared clumsy and pathetic, but as she watched, the woman was taken by the creature's unrelenting perseverance. Even after the monster crested the hill and vanished, its noble form and simple mission stayed with her. Admiration was too weak a word to describe her feelings. Donald Trump gains the vermin obsession disorder. What is the vermin obsession disorder, Doc?
I believe they can't do anything to if there's a bug pile on the board. They must.
They have to get the bug pile.
I'll get the card for Twitch Box here.
Donald Trump quietly stole back into the settlement, waking no one. Although the others slept soundly, she remained awake, invigorated by witnessing such dedication and exertion. She searched the settlement for the smoothest object she could find and began to roll it, emulating the monster. She would teach the settlement its ways and show them the perfect persistence. Gain the round stone training innovation. You may now add the Dung Beetle Knight to the quarries list.
Okay, so...
Yawkmule, the vermin are immigrants. Oh, God.
So this says, Vermin Obsession, you love insects. While there is a bug spot terrain tile on the showdown board, you are so overwhelmed that you are doomed.
So you can't spend survival till you... that token's collected.
So what is... do I write this down as a fighting art? Or
disorder.
Disorder, yeah. So what's next, Josh?
Sunstalker.
I'm getting there. Sunstalker. This is a thick one.
It's alternate campaign too.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay. Promise under the sun. There once was a boy and a girl who met under the blanket of darkness and counted the lights in the sky together. When their lips touched, the sun dawned for the first time. I have a crazy dream to share with you, said the girl. We will hunt down that light and live under it, together, forever. I swear to you we'll live that dream together, said the boy. He felt the promise swell in his heart. The girl and the boy grew into a man and a woman. Together, they cooked many meals, repaired weapons, fought monsters, and gave up on starting a family. Although their childhood promise was forgotten with the passage of time, they shared a great love. But one day, the woman fell ill. As they lay counting the lights in the sky like they always had, the sun finally dawned again. Excitedly, the man turned to the woman, but she had stopped counting some time ago. Beneath the warmth of the sun, he kissed her cold body goodbye and remembered their promise. He decided that he would hunt the sun so that he may bury her with it. Nominate a survivor.
Valkyrie says, you're now imagining that the boy and girl are Trump and Hillary. Now I am.
We need to nominate a survivor.
Nominating a survivor, okay.
What is the burning ambition fighting there? I'm not sure what this is. Josh ever gets to it. That's burning something else.
Anyone just joining in, we are giving away a signed copy of the Sci-Fi Twilight Night promo figure signed by the creator Adam Boots.
Can't skip the next one.
Well, that's cool.
And Shoshi, the queue's rolling over, so I believe they're coming up soon.
Nominate Deep Fried Oreo. That's a male, right?
It's totally a male.
Okay, so Deep Fried Oreo.
Yeah, Twinkie's the male.
It doesn't matter. It just says nominate a survivor.
Okay. So Oreo is who they're nominating?
Deep Fried Oreo is
nominate
the female.
Nominate two survivors to go to the Serbian full suite and make me.
So they get the Burning Ambition fighting art. So Deep Fried Oreo has Burning Ambition. Someone cooked the Deep Fried Oreo too long. You add the Sunstalker to the quarries list.
Okay.
Some stop.
Next.
Did you already tell me to put some
Dragonite
on the
Yeah.
Head?
Yes.
I told you everything, and we're going through this right now.
Dragon King. Glowing crater?
Yeah.
A fiery light slices through the sky. Nominate a survivor. They are the only witness. I need a survivor.
Nominate a survivor. Okay. But what?
No.
Yes.
No, we want someone else.
Want someone new.
Yeah. This is something very good for someone new, and this will be a fist and tooth person, probably.
Are you doing mad at sabotage or not shaves his head when I crit?
Spare? Misery?
Sabotage would be good.
Okay.
Why?
He's plus one strength.
Mm. Okay. I'm worried about accuracy more than strength. No one has any plus accuracy, though.
No, no one has anything, so.
So we're going to go with Mad at Sabotage?
Yeah.
Okay. So Mad at Sabotage is the only witness. The Mad at Sabotage sets out into the dark, certain that their fate awaits in the place the light landed. They gain the Destined Disorder. So Josh, what is the Destined Disorder?
Grab it.
Hi, Oxyam. The giveaway is going to be
yeah.
sci-fi Twilight promo figure signed by Adam Poots, the creator of Kingdom Death. You can check your... I know you've been here before, but as a reminder, you can check your points at any time, exclamation point points, and exchange the points for tickets, exclamation point tickets.
If you do not depart, lose all survival and insanity.
So, Destined, if you do not depart, lose all survival and insanity. So it's actually very beneficial for Mad at Sabotage to keep going on hunts over and over again. Mad at Sabotage, they reach a steaming crater's edge in time to see a pale, slender form emerge from a massive, steam-filled husk. A piteous sigh falls over the surroundings like a heavy pall as the naked form strides away, unscathed and unmoved. The witness dives into the crater, sending glittering embers of paper ash into the air. Breathlessly, they sift through the debris, searing their hands on the still-burning remains. Mad at Sabotage gains the Destiny Husk Rare Gear and the Acid Palms ability. Acid Palms adds 1d10 strength to your wound attempts when attacking with Fist and Tooth. So Mad at Sabotage is now going to be the Fist and Tooth Man.
So 1d10?
1d10 to Fist and Tooth wounds. The witness arrives at the settlement wearing nothing but a milky green membrane held tight around their body by their burnt-up hands. In their eyes is a boundless look of peaceful resignation. You may now hunt the Dragon King added to the quarries.
So he got the Husk of Destiny, which is, your destiny is fulfilled, you are always insane.
Mad at Sabotage is always insane.
Yes.
Okay.
So I could also give him the cleaver if he wants to.
Ooh, that would be good.
Which would work also.
So you can go for the hits initially with the Fist and Tooth until we get a little bit better with it, and then we can cleave. I like that. That works.
So.
Okay, so that is all of the stories. Oh no, we have to do Gorm Climate now.
Yeah, Gorm Climate. D10 roll, please.
D10 roll. Okay, let's see. Shoshi. So it's exclamation point, roll D10.
And let's, hopefully it's a good one. We haven't, I'm not going to jinx it.
It's all your fault. It's always your fault.
Not going to jinx it.
Do it.
Not going to.
Do it.
Not doing it. Shoshi. Shoshi B1.
She's so annoying.
What?
Eight.
Very good.
Woo-woo.
Do we have storytelling, Josh?
No.
The settlement struggles against the quaking ground, linking arms to brace themselves against the storm. Nominated survivor with 0 hunt XP. They gain plus 1 courage.
Thanks.
Take care of
that,
Josh.
You got 9 people in the queue today. That's
good. That's
high.
I'm going to give it to Deep Fried Oreo.
Deep Fried Oreo gets courage. So what next, Josh?
We get to do innovate.
Okay. Always be innovating.
Grab 4 cards. Oh, we kind of have a pull currently up. So.
That's 4. That's fine. We'll take care of this. So we got pottery, pictograph, hovel, and quoria.
Hovel.
God damn it, because pictograph, we keep getting stuff for pictograph.
But hovel lets us get
saviors. And plus 1 survival limit as well. And departing survivors gain plus one survival. That's a very
good
card.
Gets the family and all that good stuff too, so...
We have added plus one survival, so our max is now 5. Yeah, we got Hubble Valk.
Alex and Sam left the queue instead of a late crowd.
Oh.
That's also going to get us the bed, partnership, and a bunch of other cool innovations to do in the
future.
Super
cool. So how many innovations do we have left, Josh?
3.
3 innovations. Okay. So I think that it's time for us to make some babies.
Is that what we want to do, though?
Or what other options do we have?
We can make some leather.
Make it quick.
I'm working on it.
Make it quick. Oatmeal, time for super babies.
And I would also recommend possibly doing shared experience to get Mattis Sabotage one more hunt XP so
we
they
can
start,
start
doing what,
yeah.
Weapon proficiency.
I agree
and
with that.
Could even do it with. No, Bill can get his now.
Actually, the plus one courage, no one with two courage. To give it 2 so they can be a matchmaker?
I don't think we have any 0 hunt XP people with 2 courage, unfortunately.
Yeah.
And it's specifically for 0...
Babies.
Yeah, they're saying babies, Josh.
Babies!
They want the babies.
I
could have given it... I'll give it to...
Think of the babies! I want the babies!
Because he got 1 courage before, so we'll get 2.
That's fine.
Hubble, do Hubble.
We did Hubble.
Yeah, we got Hubble.
They want to make babies, though.
Babies.
Time to make babies, Josh.
We,
right.
We
do they don't want to hunt?
Quote, Shoshi, bebes.
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 Alright.
Babies.
Yes, babies. Okay.
How is baby formed? Well, when a mommy survivor and a daddy survivor...
pork each other very much.
You're such an idiot.
It's porking.
How much... Oh,
this is why you're single.
I don't think this is why I'm single.
There's a lot of reasons why you're single, but that's one of them.
Okay, there we go. That sounds a little bit better.
You already have partnership, Josh.
What?
You already have partnership.
We do have partnership.
Always be grinding those organs. Aw, yeah.
So, we have...
Charlton.
4 hides. Which means we can make 4 leathers...
Oregon Grand
and start making another armor set.
Go for it.
So that's 1 endeavor.
Go for it.
Then you have 2 endeavors if you guys want to make those for babies.
Okay, so Quick Foxy, please pull the first person in the poll and have them roll a
d10. The first person in the poll. He's not single, he's available, sure. But people are actually bidding on dates with him.
Currently, the bid is at 3. Right? No, it's In-N-Out Burger.
It's In-N-Out Burger.
Yeah. Someone, Keganis, I believe, has offered to buy me a meal of In-N-Out Burger for a date. So they're currently winning.
Dead Pickle, if you could roll a d10, exclamation point, roll d10.
Dead Pickle.
Dead Pickle.
Pickle.
I want Pickle really bad right now. Thanks for following, Neo Melkin.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. We hit just over 650 followers tonight. That's super exciting.
No, God, Charles Fox, right. No. No, no nut shots.
Charles here? Dates with Matt. Dates with Matt.
Currently the winning bid is In-N-Out Burger.
It is. You're a cheap date. I would expect nothing less. You're not worth much more. Matt, you need to get yourself out there. Have you considered streaking through populated areas?
That's how I got arrested the first time.
Oh, okay.
So at least this will come
along. Wait, what? Why do I have like 100 points? I don't even...
You get 1 point for every minute that you're watching.
So you might have been here for 100 minutes, or we've just done random bonuses that add up.
Or maybe they're wondering why they only have 100.
Possibly.
I don't know. You can clarify.
Are you free when I met you? You were taken.
I am free now, Newt. Single and ready to mingle. Single and staying single.
Alright, I made 3 pieces of the leather armor set.
3 pieces of leather armor set?
Yes.
Okay, perfect. So, I don't think you ever pulled the next person in the pull to roll d10. Or you did, it was Pickle.
Pickle.
Did Pickle roll? Pickle did not roll, so maybe you want to pull the next person.
Did the roll queue roll over? Yes, it is rolling over, so when you roll, you automatically get put back in the queue. The only time you don't get put back in the queue is if we call you in the queue and you don't roll. So, like, right now, since Pickle didn't roll, I'm moving on to the next person and they're no longer going to be in the queue unless they join again. KG, well, next time you and I do them.
No, you can't see. What the hell are you doing?
Killing him. Hitting him.
Because he's being a cop.
Matt, next time you and I can bounce butts in the club, it was Josh's turn last time.
Oh, God.
You really hit him.
It wasn't particularly nice.
I think we should set up Grindr as an alternative dating site. That might work.
Wait, we need someone to roll a d10.
Okay,
Cage
rolled a 4.
Cage rolled a 4, okay, so that means plus 1 survival to... Who do we have doing it?
Missing John.
Okay, one more d10.
One more d10, alright.
Yes, ma'am.
Loyal Sin. Melissa Minfield rolled for us. Make sure she's still here. I'm seeing her chat being particularly chatty today. Miss her.
Chit chat.
There she is.
And that's a 5. That is another plus 1 survival. So no babies.
Matt should live stream his date.
Oh, God.
He should.
We did not get any babies, unfortunately.
No
babies.
Aww.
But I think we're ready to pull the poll so we can see who we're going to fight.
Alrighty, let's do that. If you want to vote in the poll, you have one more second to do so.
I mean, with the delay, you're
no,
gonna...
1 second. Right now, I'll be done. Seriously, Matt, when you go for that burger, don't put out unless they pony up for the shake.
They're not getting any unless I get animal style. And then they'll get animal style.
We don't see me doing a live thing with finding JP Kill is setting the mood music. It's gonna end up in Vegas with like a Elvis and Jack. Elvis.
Elvis wedding.
An Elvis wedding, yes. Always be streaming. Can you imagine JP Killa setting the mood music? Pick something interesting.
We want to get rid of Gorm Climate Vetter.
It is a tie.
For?
Gorm and Dung Beetle. Dung Beetle.
Did it really just get a vote?
It really just got a vote.
Alright! So we're going to do Dung Beetle.
We're going to die.
So if someone gives you animal style, they in return get animal style?
I made that joke.
Okay. But that's your cost.
Yep.
That's your price. That's the price on your...
Alright.
Aw, Wilson left the queue. We'll miss you, Wilson.
So here. So we are fighting Dung Beetle?
Yes, we're fighting Dung Beetle. We're about to die.
Matt,
we have no idea.
If this perfect tomorrow, but you wanted a KDM-themed wedding, would you consent?
Absolutely.
Josh, can you hit Matt again? I missed it.
No.
It'll be a highlight.
Better aren't you, the TOS guy? The TOS enforcer?
TOS place?
Yeah.
Also, you totally deleted the Josh command, didn't you? I didn't do shit.
I didn't know.
What Josh command?
I didn't touch the Josh command.
I don't know what...
Category, let's not send all our good survivors to get butchered. I want to go and kill the Dung Beetle Knight.
I think the best chance is with our good survivors.
Well, have a good night, Wilson. Thanks for joining us.
So I need the Dung Beetle Knight cards. There's a lot of stuff.
What level
going
Dung
on.
Beetle Knight, and this is your first time fighting him ever?
Level
yes.
1, this is our first time fighting him ever.
You particularly, or...
Yes.
Others?
Yes.
Wow.
Both.
Well, how are we going to have fought him on stream, but not ever?
Or at least add a TPK vote to option on RevloCon.
Yes, that should always be an option.
Okay. Katie and Wang would go wrong. Survivors have intimacy with whoever they
Unless
want.
Unless you have partnership. Unless you have partnership.
All right, so... Oh, can I have the
arguments
for the... The screaming antelope.
Yes.
Matt, since your first time?
I am a Dung Beetle virgin.
Can I have the other cards for
me? You can certainly try.
Grab the other random hunt events. Basics.
Decoy, this is a fun fight.
If it had Sunstalker, we could have been a contender. Well, at least they'll be funny to watch.
Oh, God. This can't be good with the way that everyone's... And especially, so, for those of you that don't know, one of our usual watchers, is a creative force on this game, and he did the Manhunter. He was the
big
main
one. Is the Dragon King though? That was his baby.
Oh, was it really?
Yes. Manhunter. He was given a lot of control over of refining, but the Dragon King was his.
So we met him at Gen Con. He is a very nice guy. That's Zenith. However, he did express to us that Dung Beetle Knight is extraordinarily hard, and he wasn't sure if a level 3 Dung Beetle Knight was entirely possible to defeat. So,
basically, and considering how many times they play test this, how many times they've seen it being played, how many times they've played it for fun, if he's not sure, it probably can't be done.
TP, can you give me less bullets? Thank you very much. Nominated all the pun names.
So, yeah.
Shoshi, you met him at Gen Con too. Cool.
Matt, would you prefer a monster?
Not at all, because I want to be able to sleep tonight. Okay, so who did we leave off at, Josh? Who did we leave off at? I believe I was the last person to...
I believe so.
Okay, so we're going to have you go first, and you're going to go twice.
Thank
you very much.
You're very welcome.
So, are we sending the same party in?
I'm like the only one who missed him. Where were you, Newt? Why?
So, I'm playing as Bill Clinton. I'm going to go for it.
I'm going to keep my eyes.
We're going to go for this.
Go for broke.
I asked her politely, Valk.
TP drink it on you for yourself. No. Come on, it's Kingdom Death Monster.
Monster. Oh, I get it.
It's too busy with meetings. Newt, you were just so popular. I mean, you would have been lucky to meet you.
Okay, so you're taking Trump out again. We're doing this again, guys.
Okay.
So what do we get on departing? 3?
2.
You haven't last
3.
We
Hubble gives
it.
You plus 1, 2.
Depart, or that's
not
max.
Departing 2.
Departing 2?
Yep.
Okay, so
add 3 survival.
Okay.
If
up to 5.
Up to 5.
So we're max survival.
And set up the Revlo.
I'm doing that.
Bet.
So we're doing Donald Trump.
Bill Clinton. Matt is Sabotage. And Matt shaves his head when I crit.
Isn't that funny?
Ikoi says this fight is a fucking riot if you haven't been spoiled on it. It's pretty fun. I haven't been
TBK.
Spoiled. This is
no spoilers yet, so...
And you know what's funny?
You get a shitload of resources.
You know what I find that's
oh
funny?
Oh my god, you get a lot of resources. What?
What's funny is Newt says that he was so busy with meetings, and yet he hung out with us twice for at least an hour each time.
That's because we're such wonderful people.
We are. We're more... I think he just said that we're more important than boots. I think by proxy that is what he's saying.
By Twitch proxy
that is what he's saying.
Okay.
And
so,
I accept.
So interesting, while you set that up, we were talking to Zenith,
uh-huh.
And he was talking about the Dung Beetle Knight.
Yeah.
And he said the original build of the Dung Beetle Knight
was impossible.
No. That too. But he had his Dung Beetle ball.
Yeah.
At the beginning of the fight, he kicked it, and then he left the ball alone the whole game.
Yeah.
And he's like, it totally defeated the purpose of
the ball.
The poop ball. So a little tidbit of information that most people did not know about.
No, come on. I got in the meeting with Foods.
The RX, yes. Sabotage is the one who got the fist and tooth upgrade. They got acid palms, so that gives them an additional D10 strength roll, which it's basically giving them sharp.
Yeah, basically gives them sharp on there.
They have sharp hands.
Sharp hands. Yeah. Alright.
So the Dung Beetle Knight, it has 10 AI cards, so it has 11 hit points.
Toughness, though.
Toughness of 12! Shit!
Yep.
Okay.
Matt has acid palm, that explains
and
a lot.
And a movement of 7. No, actually, yeah, Matt is sabotage.
Charles, we have not used any of the chick names yet because...
We actually haven't made any babies yet. We've tried.
We've tried and failed to make the
babies. Yeah, but we have you in the queue for babies. Baby names.
So So, I'm up first.
Okay.
Right in my left. 83.
83. The Flesh Monolith. This was the one that revived someone.
Is it?
I believe so. The survivors approach a five-sided monolith made of flesh that stretches into the darkness overhead. Limbs and faces of humans and creatures all alike protrude from all sides. Roll on the table, Josh. Oh, maybe not. Oh, yes. If you roll. Really?
That?
Yeah.
I did that.
A dead survivor is reborn. The monolith rushes into the ground, leaving a previously fallen survivor in its place. Take the record sheet of a dead survivor and resurrect them with a founding stone and cloth gear. The reborn survivor may accompany the survivors on the hunt or return to the settlement. When they die, they rot into the pile of mush and form a new flesh mountain, leaving no corpse behind. So guys,
mm-hmm.
We get another survivor back.
You get one that died. So we technically...
Kagerite says clone Donald Trump.
We could technically bring back Donald Trump.
Clone Donald Trump! Trump reborn!
Wait, we'll have double Trump?
We'll have double Trump. We'll have
double
a male
Trump
and a female
trouble.
Trump.
Double Trump trouble! We could make Trump babies!
No, he's partnered. He can't.
No!
What a wasted possibility.
Unless Mo dies.
Which might happen.
Let's kill Mo.
This is the greatest thing ever.
So
Trump is back.
He gets his fighting arts and stuff. We need to
lost
the card.
Oh,
so
we
need
did.
To update this to Trump. Trump had what did Trump have when he died?
200, 1 XP.
Can you do that?
Yes.
You can do this, even though he technically infused his brain into Hillary.
Yeah.
Yep.
Because his body's still there.
Yeah, it was his body.
Fudge, Jesus.
Does
he come back with cannibalism and all that other shit?
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Hashtag Mo must die.
Can I see your sheet real quick? Because I think he had some other stuff. Let's see if I can see it on the sheet. So he had the murder thing.
Die, take over Hillary, come back 3 years later.
Wait, he had Red Fist, too.
He had Red Fist.
So wait, we
he
have...
four courage.
We have two people with Red Fist.
Yes. So we get plus two strength.
Oh my god. what was the disorder? He had Skull Eater.
A Skull Eater was an impairment.
It's an impairment?
Yes. I believe he had one natural strength.
Yep, he did.
And he had 100 XP, 4 courage with Matchmaker.
Okay, and any understanding?
No, he hadn't.
Yeah, I don't think he had any.
I don't think he had. What, no, was he born after he started? He wasn't an original survivor.
No, he
so
was.
Was he was the one of the original 10?
I believe he was, yeah.
Okay, so yeah, he would have no understanding.
Survival?
Do you realize why this is happening now?
What?
Newt says, so even if Trump dies in this fight, we have another Trump back at home.
No.
We can bring him with us.
No, we can bring him with us.
Why? You think you're going to
because
be
we
getting...
get
we
two...
get double Red Fist, so everyone would get plus 2 strength tokens.
Wow.
And there's a fifth person to take it.
Double Trump trouble.
Wait, we get to bring a fifth person along?
Yes.
Wow.
So we actually
might beat the Dung Beetle.
I don't know.
Double Trump. The Dung Beetle will not be able to stand the double Trump, hopefully. All right, here you go.
Also, panda.
Double fisting. No one can take down two Trumps. Alpha Decay says it gives everyone a better chance.
It does.
So what is this that costs Trump?
So wait, we'd have 5 on the fight? Yes, we'd have 5 on the fight. This is Trump 2.0.
What called this?
I'm gonna get, Flesh Monolith.
Spell that.
Flesh.
Space.
Monolith.
M-O-N-O.
L-I-T-H. Are you tweeting this?
I am.
Are you tagging Poots in it?
Yes, I am.
Wait, I know. We cloned Trump 200 times and build a wall. A flesh monolith wall of Trumps. Oh my goodness gracious.
OG hashtag Trump is back thanks to flesh monolith. We now have two Trumps at Kingdom Death. Hashtag make our settlement great again.
I put that in everything we post, like
make our settlement
hashtag
great again.
Make our
oh
settlement
my
great
God.
Again.
But the fun, we need to kill Mo. Mo needs to die, Josh.
Yeah. All right, this is confusing me now.
Josh, Mo needs to die.
I understand.
We need
Mo will die
Trump
when the
squared baits.
Hooded knight comes, probably anyway, because he's gonna have to fight him and lose.
Trump squared babies. Yes, they will just fist into the dung and make Mad Sucksville great again.
Prepare to
attack. Could double Trump double fist a level 3 dung beetle?
I don't know.
I don't know.
And you know, the funny thing is, I did hashtag Trump.
Did you actually tag Donald?
No.
At real Donald Trump. Reward.
Tag him.
I think they mean ground.
I put hashtag Trump though, so if anyone checks hashtag Trump.
Oh my God.
Thanks for joining the queue.
Nicholas Patton wants to know what Red Fist does. So Red Fist, if you have that as a fighting art,
that's what they mean.
When you are departing, you and all other departing survivors, when the showdown starts, gain +1 strength token. So we have two people with that, so everyone gets +2 strength tokens.
Alright. I think those are the cards that started playing, and I'll put these in front of me, so... Alright. Next one. This is for every time I crit.
Sudden rumbling. You hear a low rumbling and suddenly see an enormous ball rolling right towards you. Roll a d10.
Do I have to pick one first?
No. Roll a d10. What's your courage?
1. 7.
Equal to a low. 7. You run around the ball and, using its momentum, heft yourself onto it. Gain the propulsion drive of fighting art.
I'm actually a little too scared to do that. New trait, how well two at real Donald Trumps compared to the hashtag Dungbeetle?
What's the funny name?
Hashtag Matt sucks Phil great. I hope you got the rivalry settlement event after this and Trump becomes Trump's rival. Oh God. Yes, ride the poop ball.
No, okay.
Yeah, we're looking at what the propulsion art does right now.
If we don't get Turtle Prey knockout...
DBK. Kill.
Whatever. Turtle Prey kill.
What happens if the other Donald Trump gets the kill and blow now that he's in it and he's not in the poll?
He still counts.
Everyone gets screwed?
Still counts.
So you have two chances.
So...
Highlander Trump. There can be only one!
Alright, that's
if,
our propulsion
if we don't get a TPK, I'm going to make another comment about how we survived with two Donald Trumps and after eating Poop in Her Skull and then tab real Donald.
Propulsion drive. At the start of the showdown, gain the Momentum Survivor status card. When you attack, if you have 5+ Momentum tokens, remove them all and roll a d10. Gain that amount of luck and strength when attempting to wound the first selected hit location for this attack.
Jeebus.
That's ridiculous.
Right, so
that's really
spun.
Good.
So,
is the revived Trump a Skull Eater? That is true. The revived Trump is Skull Eater.
I think you stole my pencil now.
You're awesome,
yes,
Mel. We love you too.
So this was Mad as Sabotage. So go ahead and grab the next card.
Okay, so this is for Twitch proxy, so we need a d10 to be rolled.
Charles Fox says, just wait, Trump will murder Trump.
TP, we need a d10, and this is practice dummies. You find a training grounds of sorts. Roll 1d10.
Mr. Purple, if you could roll a d10 for us, we would totally appreciate it. I wish Zenith was here. Where are
Mr. Purple
you?
Rolled a 3.
Huh? Knock it off.
You recognize one of the dummies. Gain +2 insanity and a random disorder and -1 population. So we just killed someone.
Trump killed someone?
Yes.
I'm Trump.
Well, yes.
Trump killed
so
someone.
You get a random disorder and 2 insanity. So please give yourself 2 insanity.
I don't have the insanity. For what?
And Josh, I need the disorder deck.
Okay. This is like the longest freaking description for a freaking card.
I see that.
It was the remains of Poop Wiener.
Yeah, Poop Wiener!
Wait, what just happened?
So one of the training dummies was actually a member of our settlement.
Oopsies!
Yeah.
Like, so did someone in our settlement die?
Yes, we got -1 population.
Okay.
So you got the Spiral Ganglia. At the start of the showdown, gain the Darkness Awareness Survivor status.
Wait, no. That's
we're not playing with that. Yeah, you're right.
Norfolk says, I hope Trump and Trump are the only two to survive, and you draw the settlement event that lets Trump and Trump burn off the Cerny settlement.
That would be...
Into the mist. The
oh
Trump
my
settlement.
God. you got unlucky. You cannot critically wound.
Ooh.
That sucks.
No, but as long as we survive this, we can next time we can play as OG Donald Trump.
Yeah, that's true. So you please write that down as a disorder. Unlucky, you can't crit.
So how does that differ? No crit? What
no
does
crit.
That mean?
9, like, because you actually got plus 1 luck, so 9 or 10 for you, it doesn't crit.
It's still
just, wound.
Okay,
you just can't. You can't critically wound. All
right.
Okay.
So, Matt, your turn. Random hunt.
80.
And we can't spend survival.
No, you
obviously
can spend survival now.
You can, yeah, you can spend survival now.
You're just frenzy for that.
Oh,
so,
okay.
Those tokens go away.
Yeah.
You don't have those anymore.
Well, obviously, the Hillary Trump is the inferior Trump. It's OG Trump. That's right.
The survivors... I got Lovelorn Rock. The survivors pass a ring of stones with an unassuming boulder at the center. Every survivor must roll a d10.
Roll a
d10. I'll roll for a second Trump. Okay, so... Bill Clinton is a 4. You have 2?
Yeah, I have 2.
Okay.
So we need someone to roll for... Team Donald Trump.
Unless you want
to
roll quickly, TP.
You want me to roll quickly?
No, it's up to you.
Possible.
Yes, Frenzied is gone now. That was just for the last encounter.
Okay, Nudie.
Rudy Nudie,
fresh
and
fruity. Nude rolled a 10.
Okay, so who rolled a 2?
Sabotage.
Matt is Sabotage, is smitten by the rock. They heft the boulder and carry it everywhere. Forever in love, the straggler loses one gear slot permanently to the rock. Survivor must always leave one gear space empty to hold their rock.
I'm going to get rid of the bone darts.
Okay.
I think that's the best choice. I'd rather get the Found this Stone.
I agree.
Alright, so I have a rock that I love.
And it's time to fight the Dung Beetle Knight.
Loves rock. Minus 1 gear.
All praise the rock. Dwayne Johnson?
Oh, wait. That was actually supposed to
rock
be...
Rock is love. Rock is love.
I have my character sheet switched up. That was actually every time I crit.
Okay.
Let's roll.
And now we're setting up for the Dung Beetle Knight. He starts out in the center. I need a resin Dung Beetle terrain card.
Okay.
I need 2 stone columns, and I need a bug spot.
Bug patch?
Bug spot. That is bug spot.
Resin. What else? Columns?
Yeah.
That's it?
Okay, so he starts here. This starts here.
Any randoms or no?
No randoms.
Alex and Sam is back in the queue.
I need the bug patch, Josh.
I got the queue. So they have vermin obsession, right?
Yes.
So they're doomed till they...
So you cannot spend any survival until that bug patch is gone.
Get the bug patch off.
The annoying thing is that it actually doesn't start next to us, it starts next to him.
Yeah.
So down 2 over 2.
I love crowds. Why are you hitting this
man? Don't
Can you not toss
you
seriously?
I didn't mean to do that.
Yes, you did. I wanted to put it here because I don't want it on the board.
Why don't you put it away?
Okay, so then that is in line with the monster and then 4 spaces over. 2, 3, 4. There. Okay, so Josh, can you mirror this column set up on the other side? No. Leave that where it is.
Oh, there's 2?
Yes, I said 2 before.
I didn't hear you say 2.
Okay, so, I'm sorry. That goes here, and this goes monster. That, this is...
Do we even have a 5th survivor model to pick everyone on the
Yeah.
Top?
Yes, we do. Oh, okay. We have... A buttload of survivor models.
Who are we gonna use?
So Josh is getting the 5th one right now. So
I'm
a
freaking model.
He's only got a cloth armor and a founding stone.
Yep, so he has one waist armor and a founding stone.
So he's not going to be really useful.
If no
fight.
Model, get the panda from Captain Noko.
No, I have plenty of models. I'm just debating which one I want.
Panda.
Any day now, Josh.
The panda. And I require to play as a panda.
Who do I want to use?
I use this guy's jump because he has no weapon in his hand.
Okay.
So the gray guy is Trump. Oh, and we also get a tactics card.
We could start off with Trump throwing his founding stone.
We could.
I think that would be a pretty decent lead off.
Attack pattern.
Attack pattern. At the start of your survivor turn, you may declare that you are using an attack pattern in an order. So if we name an order before, like, as we start our turn. The first survivor attacks normally, the second survivor gets +2 strength, the third survivor gets +3 strength, and the fourth survivor gets +4 strength.
Hmm. Okay.
So, Newt says, by the way, I asked last stream if Josh had any survivor's paint because I was thinking about painting a set for you guys. I have 3 survivor unarmored sprues laying around.
We do not have any painted survivors. That would be awesome, Newt.
That would be fantastic. The only thing, as far as painting goes, we just have these lovely colored bases that you see here.
Yes.
So, that'd be fantastic.
The awful.
So these are the 4 trait cards he starts with.
Okay.
So.
You pay attention to those.
Do you want to read those off so everyone knows? What
sure.
They are?
We have Baller. The monster spins the ball around itself with tremendous force. All survivors in the red zone indicated suffer collision with the resin dung ball. So that's 2 spaces surrounding the monster. Archive all destructible terrain in the red zone. Place the resin dung ball in front of the monster. So he spins the ball around him. Separation anxiety. While the monster is not adjacent to the resin dung ball, it is separated and gains a token. If an AI or hit location card has the green symbol that the token is, only apply those actions, effects, or special rules if the monster is separated, otherwise ignore them.
So you want to try to get him away from this ball.
Power forward. Do not perform this card. Okay. So this is a basic... Yeah, you want to get him away from his poop ball.
Poop ball.
And then ground pound. The monster slams the ground precisely, altering its network of prepared tunnels. All survivors adjacent to the monster suffer bash. Interesting. Okay, so this is going to be a fun fight.
Let's do this!
The dung beetle ball itself, we can push the ball 1d5 spaces away with an action.
Interesting. Okay.
So, Trump's job might just be to push the ball away from the monster since he's not going to be able to do
much. Oh, that's a good idea! Have Trump play soccer with the poop ball.
Yeah. Trump will play soccer with the poop ball. And just try to keep it the fuck away from the dung beetle knight, because the last thing we need to do.
Yeah. Zenith is here!
Zenith!
They summoned the dung beetle on us.
Well, on top of that, too, we got the flesh monolith, and Trump came back to life.
So we have double Trump.
Double Trump trouble. So, are we going to lead off with Trump throwing the founding stone?
Well, monster attacks first.
Monster.
Everyone's so excited about that thing here.
Can I have the monster controller roll? We'll start with a sabotage.
I contemplated tagging the real Donald Trump in my tweets about Donald Trump. Would that have been a bad idea?
Probably.
Probably.
Right.
So you have Trump and Hillary Trump.
Trump.
Yes,
yes, we do.
And so we have a male and female Trump. However, female Trump is currently partnered with Mo, but we want to kill Mo.
We're gonna kill Mo.
Yeah, she's female too, which is funny.
How many disorders does female Donald Trump have?
Two.
Oh. I want to try to get rid of that.
Unlucky
one.
Yeah.
Alright. Resin ball shot.
Oh, gosh.
Further stinky survivor. Is anyone stinky?
I'm not stinky.
I'm not stinky.
Matt of Sabotage is stinky.
Does he really? Oh, he has the fecal stuff?
He has the monster grease.
Oh, the monster grease is stinky.
Yes,
oh,
monster grease
okay.
is stinky. Turn the face target and perform baller.
Where is Matt of Sabotage?
He's right here. So he's just facing him. He doesn't move.
No.
Move the ball 2d10 spaces through the target. On collision, any survivors suffer 5 damage to 1 hit location.
What? Pick target. Furthest stinky survivor, closest threat. Turn to face survivor and perform baller. So baller means that the ball moves around him.
Spins around him. It hits anyone in that space.
Move the ball 2d10 spaces through the target.
So 2, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay, so it doesn't do anything. And it's our turn. You can dash between flows, remember, says
Decoy.
Yes,
we can. So that would be a good thing to do. Alright, so he is actually separated from his ball right now.
Yes. So, do we want to have Trump do...
I think Trump should definitely do ball control. I don't know if we want to do...
Oh, does he have any survival?
You can dash between...
I don't remember what his survival was. Oh, everyone gets +2 strength tokens.
Yes!
Oh, yeah.
Also, the ball should have been in front of the Duncan, and you forgot that.
Is it in front?
No.
Oh, wait.
Monster spins the ball around.
The ball should have bowled through you guys.
It didn't actually have enough space to reach us. And the starting location says that the ball starts behind the monster. So, don't know. I don't think we did that wrong.
I don't think so either.
Thankfully, you rolled terribly.
I don't have enough strength tokens to give out.
We all have 2 strength.
We all have 2 strength tokens. Just to
make Hagrid says after baller, you place the ball in front.
Does it say that?
Doesn't it? I don't think it says that on there, but...
But it's a thing.
The ball always ends during baller in front of the Dung Beetle Knight.
Okay, so then you would move 7?
Yeah.
So, 1...
But who's mad is Sabotage?
2... technically, the blue, I believe. So, 1, 2... What did I roll? 7?
7.
So it would end.
Equal is correct, and it confirms. Thank you.
Alright, cool.
So
thank you, non-confidence.
We take
following.
5 damage.
And
to
it takes. It technically
but we
takes.
Can, but we can dash.
Yes, it can dash.
It did fall. I made sure that that worked.
Okay.
So I'm going to dash.
Yeah. I'm assuming you guys are going to dash, or otherwise you take 5 damage to 1 hit location. Why don't you dash closer?
Because I have the Vesper team.
What's
range? Right. So 1, 2, 3.
You can go through.
Can you?
This
move
person
hand?
Moves first.
I
you don't have.
See.
If,
I can't
if
see.
If the person goes first, then you can. So Matt is Sabotage. Doesn't use survival.
You quite said, like I said earlier, you got to pay attention to DPK's order of operations. It's easy to forget.
So it says dash up to him for the reckoning. Now, wherever you move Matt is Sabotage is where the ball's going to go, Josh.
That's true. So if I go over here,
yeah,
then the ball will just come after me.
Right, and it shouldn't be able to reach you now.
I don't think so.
It is a 2x2.
Yes, it's a 2x2.
So
that's why it's in the middle.
So
right,
now
so
have
that,
the ball. Just have the ball go.
Yeah.
Down.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
It actually can't reach you.
Hello, buddy, buddy.
You got a poop ball right up in your grill.
Right in my grill.
Technically right up in Matt's grill.
Okay.
Matt, it's Sabotage's grill. So it is our turn now.
It's our turn.
So I'm going to shoot him with the clawhead arrow first.
Okay.
And that is a 6+ accuracy. I hope I hit it. Damn it.
Alright.
Missed the clawhead arrow. Sorry, guys.
And do you want to move? What's chat saying?
Yeah, so they just said make sure you do your dash before you roll for distance next time. Uh-huh. Yeah, no problem. That was just... We're learning. This is our first time.
Hey, well, we'll do it next time.
You know, it should have been in this fight, poop winner.
Oh, yes. We could... I forgot. I said we can declare for our attack. But it doesn't matter now. I already went first, and I missed, so...
Sure. So it doesn't matter. Okay. Are you moving at all, or...
Me?
Yeah.
No, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
You could technically move through my character.
Do we want to have Trump throw the Founding Stone? Or do we want to save that?
Unless you want to check the hit location deck, use a Surge to do it.
I don't want to do that.
If there's a good card up there, but you might want to wait for later.
I don't have a Rawhide Armor set, so I can't regain my...
Yeah, I'm just saying, like...
Thanks for following, Beedrix.
Thank you.
If we want to... When we use that, it should definitely be a check to see if there's any good crits. I don't
yeah.
know if we can crit a crit him, so...
That's true. So I'm going to have Trump run up and kick the ball, I think. 3, 4, 5. I would be adjacent to the ball.
Okay.
So I'm going to do that.
So roll a...
D5. 6, so it moves 3 spaces away.
Yeah, 3 spaces away.
And this gets destroyed.
Yeah, that gets destroyed. Right. So the ball's there.
Okay, and remember, Twitch can't attack until that's gone.
No, they can't use survival.
Can't use survival.
Yes.
Okay.
So, Twitch, if you guys want to attack, you can punch him in the face.
I'll punch him in the face. Can't punch him in the butt?
No, you
no.
can't reach his butt, but you can't punch him in the face.
Okay.
So, I need you to roll 2d10s.
Well, we have an extra speed.
No, you don't.
Why?
Because you don't have that anymore. I told you to take that away last time.
Oh, you did? Both of us the luck, too?
No, you keep the
no,
luck.
You keep the luck. You lost the speed to get the luck.
No.
Yes.
No, you
it
got
was
a token.
Temporary.
It's a temporary. You got a token.
Cheater.
No, I thought something else happened
no.
because I took it away and then I put it back.
Because you did the wrong thing.
Okay.
But so we need 2d10s to be rolled. Try to get as close to the bug patch as you can, attack, then move up to grab the vermin next turn.
Yeah, or someone else could grab the vermin,
yeah.
too.
We'll all try to get to it, I'm sure. Actually, we could have Trump do that, or besides him playing soccer with the poop ball.
Yeah. I could actually have Matt...
I could also Surge and use the Vespertine bow, try and do some damage to him.
Did Josh get a haircut? No, he shaved.
Who is that?
Zen.
Oh, yeah, they made me shave. It was on the beginning of one of the streams.
A 10 and 8.
10.
That's yeah, 2x. Matt actually shaved him with a straight razor.
Shave that, but close enough. So you're attacking the filthy face and the side of Resin Ball.
This is starting to hit location.
Ah, very good. So just because the poop ball is away from him, we got to discard and draw a new hit location card.
Yeah, space haircut. Same thing, yeah.
So now you're attacking the iridescent leg. So because he doesn't have the poop ball next to him, the monster crushes a keystone. Move the ball 1d10 spaces towards the monster. Cancel the reaction on this card. So I'm going to do that second.
Yeah, so all right, go ahead and attack. So let's roll 1d10. Get 1d10 rolled.
Oh, wow. If you attack with a club or shield, gain +4 strength to this location.
So shields are good? And clubs?
Yes. So I need you to roll d10. What is your strength on your weapon?
And they should have one natural strength, right?
Shoshi, if you could roll for us, and our strength on our weapon, which number is that again?
The last one.
Bottom number?
6.
Okay, and what is, do you have any natural strength, TP?
They should have one from being nominated for that thing.
I have no strength.
You should have one.
I should have one. Okay.
You gain one
yeah.
during that thing. So, what was it?
A six plus
seven.
3.
Yeah, plus 3, so...
It's a 9, which means you need a 3 plus to wound.
Yeah, 3 plus to wound.
And they rolled a
6.
So it is a wound.
So
you're telling me different things, and I wouldn't erase things if you...
No, we told you the right things. You're a little absorbed in chat sometimes. It's fine. It happens.
Alright, so we will.
So, you're attacking the iridescent leg, so Josh, roll the d10, please. And this is how many the poop ball goes towards him. So, 6 spaces.
Dead pickle, if you want to join the queue, it's !! Join.
Here, right?
Yeah.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Matt, you want to give me water, please?
You're... No.
Jabawa Bamu says, is Dung Beetle greater than Antelope?
Dung Beetle's supposed to be extraordinarily hard.
Extraordinary.
Yes. And then this is canceled?
Yes, that's canceled.
Canceled the reaction on this hit location. So if they failed, it's the reaction. So they can still attack. It just cancels the reaction.
No, yeah,
cancels
the reaction. I didn't say
so
it.
So they can still...
Oh, yeah,
wound.
No, yeah, they still wound.
All right, so
I'm sorry.
They roll, need to roll a d10.
So, yeah, I'm sorry. Roll another d10, please.
Okay.
So, yeah,
Paige,
we take advantage
take
of the
that?
Poop ball being away
yeah.
from
him. Totes, Mr. Fightful. That's exactly what's happening. Cage rolled a 1.
That's a fail.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
So you can't spend any survival.
Nope.
I can spend a survival. I'm going to spend a survival and shoot it with the Vespertine bow.
Kate said, make that for the ball. That's how far the ball moved. don't think it works that way, Cage.
We already moved the ball, unfortunately.
Do you want to wait till next turn, use your hit location, check first to see what crits are there, and then... Instead of doing it now.
Why?
Because that's a crit. If you're using your arrow. Your arrow or your bow?
I'm using the bow, not
okay.
the arrow. So it's a 3-speed. That was not a roll. It is a 3-speed, 6-plus accuracy.
Is it?
Yes.
Cumbersome?
No.
Shit rolls downhill. But it does.
9, 4, 3, 1 hit.
Super dense.
I'm attacking the Sentry Carapace. Plus 6 toughness to wound this location. Gain plus 2 d10 strength when attempting to wound this location with a club, shield, or pickaxe.
Okay.
I'm just going to call him Jabba, because it's...
Interesting.
Jabba says, all my settlements and end with the Flower Knight killing too many people and then getting reamed by level 3 nemesis.
Yeah. You're deadly, right?
Yes, I'm deadly.
That's a crit.
Don't get done, you
know. So it's a wound?
No.
No, there's no crit location.
There's no crit location, so it's not a crit.
It's a failure. You feel hopeless, lose 1 survival.
What's your strength?
6 strength,
so
plus 2.
15.
Plus
say
4.
Hey,
so it's a 10. Where are you getting 15 from?
You rolled a 9.
Rolled a 9, I'm sorry. Yeah, 9
plus
10. 6. Actually, 19.
19. So that...
Plus 6 times. It's actually a wound.
It's a wound.
Oh, damn.
Yeah.
Instead of wounding this monster, archive this card and gain 1 survival. If you attack with a pickaxe, gain an additional 3 survival. So this card gets archived. It doesn't come up ever again.
It's come up again.
Thank God. And I gain a survival, actually. So I don't use that survival that I just spent.
All right.
Are you guys going to say hi?
Who? Crickham? Hi.
Hey, Crickham. Sorry,
oh, okay.
I wasn't.
I'm just surprised you got you.
I was absorbed. I'm sorry. Hey, Crickham, how's it going?
Yeah, we had something going on, and we're just trying to figure out what's happening.
I was just joking because you guys say I get distracted. I didn't even know if you knew who I
no,
said.
No,
no. We heard. It just...
Completely absorbed. So, Josh, it is your turn.
Okay. I'm going to run forward.
You should feel bad, Java. You should.
I'm attacking with...
The...
My... Axe.
Pole axe?
No, my axe.
Oh, your axe. You need... It does have reach.
It has reach.
So, Crickham wants to know if we're having fun, and we're having a ton of fun, because Donald Trump just came back from the dead.
And we have 2 Donald Trumps now.
Because the original Donald Trump took over Hillary Clinton's body.
Yes.
This would have been so nice.
Now we have dual Donald Trumps, one male, one female.
I don't have the green affinity for this. Oh, I got...
Oh, pretty good.
Really, Josh? You have 2 Sentry Carapaces. How much strength do you have?
4. 4.
On your weapon is 4?
Yeah.
You also have plus 2 from
yes,
the...
6.
So you need to roll a 8 or higher?
What's this number?
No, plus 6, 12, 18.
18.
You cannot hit it unless you roll a 10.
Yeah, 10's auto hit still.
Then it!
Nope.
So if we survive, we're making Donald Trump fuck himself, right? Right?
As long
if Mo dies.
As long
we
as
gotta
Mo
kill
dies,
Mo.
We have to kill Mo.
We have to kill Mo.
You lose 2 survival.
2 survival? Okay.
And then, yes, that's all that's going to be happening.
Oh, we really want to have a shield or club.
My other
or pickaxe.
My other character has a...
Pickaxe does it, too.
But it's frail.
Ikoi says, when you perform a survival action, roll 1d10, not any time you spend survival.
Yeah, survival action. Yeah.
Yeah.
He did that. He hit this card that gave him black 1 survival, so he didn't use it.
Yeah.
It wasn't that he rolled to...
Oh, yeah.
It was the card itself said if you wound it, you get 1 survival.
Wilson is back.
Hey, Wilson.
All right. And then it is...
You can kick the poop ball.
Dead Pickle, thanks for following.
You actually moved it closer to him by doing that?
No,
you
I can
move it in any direction.
Any direction. Push. With resin ball, 1d4 spaces directly away from you.
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever. It's still not adjacent to him. Alright, I think that's it for all of us. So monster's turn?
Monster's turn.
So Matt is sabotage.
Resin ball shot. Do not perform this card. Instead, perform ground pound, then basic action.
Thanks for hosting, Crit Camp.
Hey, thank you for the host. So ground pound. Ground pound. The monster slams the ground precisely altering the network of prepared tunnels. All survivors adjacent to the monster suffer bash. You're not technically adjacent, are you?
I technically am.
Bash is knocked back?
Knocked down.
Knocked down, okay. And then perform a basic action. Oh, I'm sorry. Then the vibrations create a natural ramp. Move the ball 1d10 spaces towards the monster.
So I'll go right next to
him. Yeah. Okay, and then perform a standard action.
Standard action closest knockdown survivor, which is going to be Twitch.
Ooh.
A speed of 3. They have 1 evasion, so 4 plus accuracy. A lot of fucking damage.
One hit.
I recommend dodging.
Yes, please dodge this.
It's 4 damage.
You can't use
any survival. Yes, that's
true. Oh, yeah.
So you need
I
to roll.
Remember something you didn't.
Yes,
yeah.
That's true.
What, wait, what?
Yeah, you're right. So we need you to roll a hit location die. And how much damage
are
you going
to take? No, I'm going to duck.
So have someone roll a hit location die, please.
So let's see. It's going to be...
Ecoy says diagonal isn't adjacent, correct?
So WD, call us if you're still with us. I just want to make sure you're still with us. I don't believe you are, so I'm going to go ahead and pull the next
Typically
person.
It is... It's
Mr.
It's
Purple,
weird.
If you could roll hit location and exclamation point, roll HL.
Is Zenith still trying to chat? I can't see anything.
So Zenith, if you're still here, can you give us a ruling on that? Is diagonal considered adjacent to the monster?
Ecoy said diagonal isn't adjacent. That's correct.
Adjacent is adjacent to another one. It occupies a space, one space in a cardinal direction.
All right, so my guy stole them.
He says, I'm still here, what's up?
Never mind,
we
got
it.
But we wanted to know if, so he says,
Your time says no.
Okay.
That's what I get for listening to you, Josh. You're wrong.
My guy says up.
You're wrong.
Everyone says no.
And he full moves towards the monster after
everyone
the turn.
Says
so
Josh
did you roll
wrong,
a hit location card? Did you roll a hit location card?
I'm
die.
Why are you getting so mad at me? I was waiting on I'm moving to the next person. Calm down.
Okay.
Newt, if you could roll the HL for me so Josh doesn't start screaming, please.
Is that when you start hitting your knuckles?
I don't know what the hell that was from.
Ground pound isn't quite as deadly as the ball and range.
Arms.
Zenith is actually one of the game designers.
Yes.
So he technically is a KD expert.
I should go back to my full.
You should have 2.
Armor, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Yeah. Besides your head, which has 5.
Right. I just didn't know if that the legs things was from last time.
So you guys take a heavy hit on your arms.
Yes.
So you guys need to roll another D10.
Okay.
And severe injuries.
Severe injury already.
So wait, I have two armor.
How much damage is it?
4. 4 damage.
So why do they need to roll a severe injury?
Oh, sorry. Yeah, it's just a heavy hit. Sorry.
Just a heavy hit.
Yeah, just heavy hit.
Calm down.
You're off your game today, Josh.
Alex and Sam rolled a 4, but we don't need it, so I'll call Alex and Sam next time we need to roll.
Okay. So, it is now our turn.
Yes.
So, do you want to encourage them up, or...
Yeah, I'll encourage them up with a Mad Sabotage.
Good, good roll. Good roll. Right,
so, they're up. I don't use any survival. Oh, I get a token for that movement. No, that's...
Step 1, push ball away.
Yeah. I'm going to have Donald Trump go.
Xanax for everyone.
And I'm going to have him kick the ball. I can't go over to the side.
That's fine.
D5, right?
That's the 5 spaces.
5 spaces away. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You want to go and get that?
I'm thinking about it. I can't get it this turn, though.
So why don't you attack him and then just move closer?
That's what I'm trying to think what I want to do. All right, first I'm gonna run up with Mad of Sabotage. I get another token for that. I'm gonna roll with my shield.
And what is your shield's accuracy?
7+.
Ooh, hard.
But 3 dice.
Yeah.
2
hits. Very nice. 2 9s. And you are attacking the Sentry Carapace and the side of Resin Ball, but it's discarded and drawn movement, please.
So
century. Carapace gets discarded for iridescent back. Reflex turn to face directly away from the attacker. The monster beats its wings. All survivors in the blind spot suffer knockback 7.
Alright, so that's second. Alright, so...
Okay, so do the Century Carapace first. It gains plus 6 toughness to this location, so it has 18 toughness, but you roll 2d10s to your strength roll.
Alright, so first...
It's a crit.
It's a
10.
It's a confirmed. You always wound on a 10. It's not a crit.
Oh,
you always wound on a 10.
Yeah, you're right.
No matter what. So it doesn't matter what my...
So you gain plus 1 survival.
I'm at max.
And this gets discarded. Put to the side, not discarded. Removed from play. And now the iridescent ball back.
Alright, so I wound him. And then this one is...
Now, what we could do is, it says face directly away from the survivor, so we could have him technically...
I'm having this one attack.
Oh, you're attacking with him.
Yeah.
Okay, so he's attacking there.
And I get knockback 7.
Knockback 7. So you're actually going to hit that.
Chat?
Huh?
We can't do links in chat?
Who's trying to link?
Dana.
You have to grant him permission.
Oh, really?
You should be able... Yeah. Normally you can. I don't know why Dana can't.
See if I can do it without blocking him.
That's my thing.
Permanent ban...
Alright, so knockback 7. That's it. So, I moved 5 spaces again. I could have moved. Okay.
That's a mod. Because why not?
Every time I move 4 more spaces, I get a movement token. When I get 5 plus, I get that add 1d10 or...
Okay.
I made that the mod because you created the beautiful...
Any certain reason why you guys didn't attach a ball to the base?
Go for it.
I just didn't do it.
Then if you have our permission to post any link you see fit.
Yeah. Right. But yeah, it's not too bad stability wise, but yeah, I can see we're definitely gonna wind up gluing it. So it's our turn now.
Yeah, I went first.
You've
gone with Chomp already and kicked the ball.
Yes.
I hit it with my shield, which opened up the blind spot for
TP
to hit.
In the left cheek. TP left cheek time.
So 3d10s.
2d10s.
2d10s?
2d10s.
And what's 4 plus?
5 plus.
What's the card 5? Or is it a 6?
The card's a 5 plus.
So it's a 4 plus.
Oh,
yes.
So now she... Okay, so she's giving permission to pose for his or her Dung Beetle Knight. Oh my god, that is awesome.
So TP, we need 2 d10s to be rolled.
Okay, that's... You said...
Alex and Sam, have them roll again.
Oh, wow.
Oh, whoops.
That's impressive.
That's really awesome.
That is
awesome.
Amazing.
Yeah, I got distracted with that. That is...
Oh my god.
That is high.
I once.
Hi. Wait, the Instagram is show she's minis. Okay, I'm busy for the rest of the night.
That's fantastic.
Wow.
You can go back to chat if you want.
No. Wow. Hi.
I paint professionally. Yeah, it shows.
Yeah.
It shows.
Yeah. Wow.
So Zenith rolled a 3 and Nicholas Patton rolled a 5. So we
so
have
one
hit.
And the RX rolled a 2.
We only needed 2 rolls.
You told me 3.
I told you 2. Josh told you 3 and I corrected him.
Ah.
You're attacking the iridescent arm. The monster stumbles. Okay, so we need you to roll one more d10.
You don't want to count the 2?
You technically could.
You could?
Okay, we're not going to count the 2. Alright, Alex and Sam. Because I promised you.
What's your strength at?
The strength of the weapon is a 6, plus they have plus 2.
3, so
plus
it's
3,
nine.
So it's 9, so they need a 3 plus to wound.
Okay.
Zenith said, oh, I thought I was rolling for the ball, I was trying to roll blow.
Alex and Sam rolled a 4, so that is a wound.
Okay.
The monster stumbles backwards, it suffers knockback 3 directly away from the attacker.
1, 2,
and
three.
Performs ground pound. That's annoying.
Okay.
So take that, please. Ground pound. The monster slams the ground. All survivors adjacent to the monster suffer bash. That's no one.
Mm-hmm.
However, the ball rolls 4 spaces closer.
Okay.
Wow, that is a beautiful.
Okay, so Josh.
Smack it in the butt?
Yeah, I would go here and smack it in the butt, and then next turn you could run and pick up the...
Or I can smack it, then it's going to be the same
thing
anyway. So I'm going to go here.
Yes, Valkyrie. Valkyrie says, people of the stream have...
Oh, Kagarite says, destroy the bug patch, the ball went over it.
Oh, yes.
Yes!
Does it?
Does it say that for the bolt? I don't know.
And Zenith, you want to clarify that, if that happens or not?
I've never gotten
Can
a
plan. Can you tell him what you're talking about?
So, Zenith, if the ball, the dung beetle ball, rolls over the bug patch, does it destroy the bug patch?
What was that?
That was
a clipboard.
All right, I'm attacking while answering that question. I rolled a 1 and a 4, and those neither of those hit.
Okay.
So, that happened.
Oh boy. But it was your baby. You should know everything about your baby. So Valgale said, people of the stream, I've come to you with plans of destiny. We shall raid... Hang on, it's moving. We shall raid Shoshi's home, and with all our might and fury, together we shall take back our Beetle Knight and worship... Oh, it's moving. Worship it as our new god, and thus the Dung Beetle alternate campaign shall be born.
Zenith says, I think it only destroys destructible terrain.
Yeah. But, like, I know columns get destroyed.
But it says that specifically.
Oh, yes, it's destructible.
On those cards,
yeah. Yes, yeah. And it says it on those cards. So it is still there.
Okay, that's fine.
That's fine. All right, so monster's turn.
No.
Oh, I thought you won already.
No,
you didn't go this round yet.
So I'm going to.
You can move and shoot, right?
I'm going to go sniper style, though.
Snipe it.
I gain plus 4 accuracy. And 9 range, but it makes it slow, so I don't roll 1 die.
Okay, but...
It's a 6 plus to hit that one.
Okay.
So, I think I'm going to try this. I want to see how this works.
Alright.
Of
Perfect
course. wound attempt at this location fail unless the wound result is critical. God damn it.
God damn it.
Okay, so it's still deadly, so it's a 9-10. That's a 2. Full move towards the attacker. If the monster is adjacent to the attacker, it suffers bash and knockback 7. Its movement is 7. Really?
Yep.
Really?
You know what the good thing is?
I'm out of the range.
Its
ball really
is so freaking away
from
it.
It's really far away from the ball.
Alright.
We are planning on harvesting the bug patch as soon as possible. Next turn, we're going to harvest.
Next turn, yeah. That's what Matt is... every time I crit, Matt will go do that. All right, so Twitch's turn to be Marshall Troller.
Shoulder bash. Closest stinky threat. In field of view, in range. 7.
There's no one stinky in range. I'm all the way over there.
Okay, so then closest threat.
So archive the bug spot.
Did they say it? Did they confirm?
When
they
the ball collides with another terrain tile, the ball destroys it, archive the terrain tile. If the ball collides with impassable terrain...
Oh.
Oh, there's apparently in the rule book.
Okay, cool.
Yes.
So the bug tile is gone.
Thanks, then.
Okay.
It helps
so
have a
the closest
rulebook.
Threat.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. How much damage does this do?
5.
That's really...
I don't have any survival, so could you spend a survival and dash?
Yeah. I think that's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
All right. So I don't roll for that because I don't have... That's not that character.
Okay.
But I use my survival. I'm going to dash.
I picked up a sci-fi white speaker, fade, through some other... I haven't painted in a couple of years. Ah.
So he moves 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... He performs a ground pound.
Yeah, so the ball gets adjacent to him.
The ball moves 1d10 spaces.
It's only 1 speed. That figures.
It's adjacent.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's disappointing.
But it's our turn.
Okay, so it is our turn again. I stand back up.
You stand back up. I'm going to move the ball.
Do you want to surge and go again?
I can't move, and all I could do, I could attack him because I have reach, but that's
okay.
I don't. I think Twitch should come hit him in the butt first.
That's a great idea. Okay, so Twitch proxy, we need 2 d10s to be rolled.
Lucy, get off there. Get off there.
2d10s?
Yeah. Did I mess up the Twitch hand?
A little bit, but I got it.
That's a 1, Cag.
Yeah. Again, Cag. Again, Cag.
Shoshi! Oh, Mr. Frightful, good night. Thank you for joining us.
It's late over there.
Wow, yeah, it is. Good night.
Oh, what's the... Mr. Frightful did want to know what the health was up for. 7 is a hit, so...
Mr. Frightful wanted to know what?
The health is.
3, 6, so 7 health.
Okay, not bad. So, Twitch Proxy, you're attacking the iridescent breastplate. We need 1d10 to be rolled, please.
1d10.
And they need a 3 plus to hit.
They need a 3 plus to wound. That's correct.
Loyal Sim, I don't know if she's still here. She was going to bed at some point. I mean, sorry if it doesn't...
We have an interesting question.
10!
Thanks,
Loyal Sim.
That doesn't matter.
Oh, okay. With a sickening crunch, a hairline fracture shoots across the monster's thick chest. You gain plus 1 survival.
Woo-woo.
You have full.
Wait, even if I'm at 5 out of 4?
5.
It should be 5 now.
Okay, so I'm at max.
Yeah. You also get plus 1 insanity, and the monster gained minus 1 toughness token.
Nice.
So now, Twitch Proxy, you could actually spend a survival and go again, because the bug patch is gone.
Let's do it.
Chuck can actually use survival. He has plus 2 strength tokens. You can use your strength tokens as survival.
That is true.
Just an FYI.
So you wanted to hit Trump to dash over so he can get the courage.
So do I use the survival?
I'm assuming. I would say do it.
Do it. Okay. 4. And now what do we do?
Roll again.
Roll 2 more D10s.
2 more D10s. And with that, I guess she's going to sleep. Well, at least you ended on a high note, and thanks for joining us. Nuke, Nalix, and Sam, if you could roll for us. You rolled an 8.
It's a hit.
Before attempting to perform ground pound, cancel the reaction on the hit. This hit location.
He's in range, so that whatever that says is.
Oh, okay.
It's.
And Alex and Sam rolled an 8.
Listen.
And that is the first strike, and it is impervious. So Twitch Proxy, I need 2d10s to be rolled, please.
2 more d10s.
Actually, just 1 first.
Just 1.
Yeah, because this could be bad.
Mr. Purple, if you could roll for us.
And what's your courage at, TP?
Courage.
Courage is at a 2.
Okay.
Mr.
So,
Purple rolled a 10.
Oh, so that's... Okay, that's perfect.
That is a...
You would... You discard this card. Can you get the cat out of the... Like, it's right in the middle.
Get up and get him. I have to reach across and possibly knock everything down.
I know, but I have to get up and possibly flush the camera.
Oh my gosh. Okay, so nothing happens, and I need you to do 1 more D10.
Okay.
Watch your chair. I think you're hooked on the light.
I am hooked on the light. No, I'm good. New Katie extension cat.
You did 1 more?
Yeah, I did. It's presented.
Exactly. Okay. The legendary black lion.
Does that so nothing happens with that if you're all 10?
Yep, you ignore this card. It's not a 10, it's your courage.
Archive
plus...
this card, so this card is no longer in them.
Yeah, sorry.
Is that a preview of exploding kittens?
Yeah.
Please
move
your cat to
space. I don't know if Zenith is here right now, if you want to pass it.
Passy.
Passy with the gassy.
No,
oh, Zenith,
you
okay,
wanted
cool.
to skip him.
The gain 1 random Dung Beetle Knight resource. The monster vomits chunks of boiling resin that hit the ground and momentarily form an unhappy face. Gain plus 1 strength token. You may spend 4 survival to cherish this moment forever. If you do, gain plus 1 permanent strength.
Fuck
you have,
yeah.
You have 4 survival.
Fuck yeah. So wait, what was the first thing that happened?
You get a strength token, so Josh is going to get that for you now.
And now I get plus 1 permanent strength?
And you get plus 1 permanent strength.
So I'm at 2 extra strength.
You get,
so
you
see in the bottom right where under the strength? Put a 3 there. That little box.
So like this, just to clarify?
Cherish it. Cherish the fuck out of
yes.
it.
Yes. Yeah, did you spend... you guys only had 3 survival?
No, you had 4.
I already took the survival.
No, no. You had to spend 4.
4 survival.
I had spent all 4?
Yes.
Oh.
Oh.
Now I have 0 survival.
That is correct.
They surge, right?
Yes.
Roll a d10 to see if you actually survive.
Oh, that's true. Roll a d10. Sorry.
It's okay. Nicholas, if you could roll for us.
They got the... That's what they got.
You got the elytra. The ribbed underside of these large shells makes an ideal surface to grind weapons. Any survivor may archive this to give all of their attacks in the next showdown sharp.
Nicholas rolled a 10, so I get to keep that.
You have 1 survivor.
You have 1 survivor.
Yeah, we're getting a bunch of 10s. This is ridiculous.
Yeah.
So you can sharpen your fist in 2
yes.
and acid palm, so you get
plus
2d10.
plus 2d10s.
Blaster says, hey, so this is the Dung Beetle Knight. Interesting, but judging by the expansion hijinks, I'm guessing Green Knight armor is officially and utterly out of the question. Moving out of lore for this.
Yeah,
since we aren't doing all the nemesis, no Green Knight armor.
Unfortunately.
Maybe next time we'll do just the stuff for Green Knight armor, but yeah, it's just...
Yeah, that's going to be another stream down the road, probably. But for now, so that is Twitch Proxy's turn.
Yes.
That was both of her turns.
Both of her turns.
So.
I need a wound for that. No, I did that.
Okay.
Because that was at 3 before,
so
now it's at 4.
So I'm going to full move. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I'm 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9 spaces away, so I can sniper bow it.
Okay. Lucy!
That is a wound. Alright,
hit.
Really? Again? 3, I don't have that much courage. I have
1.
I have 2.
2. So that's a
if it is greater than
6.
No, it's no. You both you suffer 1 brain damage and are knocked down. Oh wow. So the question is, do we want to have Trump toss his founding stone, maybe? We need to kick that ball away, otherwise we're in trouble. I just realized that.
I can't do anything about it right now.
This is problematic.
Unless I use...
2 survival.
Both the last 2 survival I have. I'd rather...
It's going to be a pain. It's going to be bad. Can you toss me the ball card?
This is...
Oh, that's the ball card?
That's what you're... I think you're... So he does that at the beginning of his turn if the ball's
No, I want the ball.
It's time for Trump to make the settlement great again.
Oh, collision's knocked down?
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, it would knock down everyone around it.
We can dodge him for a turn, right?
That's true. They could use their survival to dash away.
Yeah, they could.
Okay, so that's fine.
Okay.
So Josh, do you have anything else that you want to do? I'm going to move Trump closer. Just so I can get into ball kicking range.
You could use a strength token. You're not using them.
Oh, that's a good idea. Yeah,
to
right.
dash and kick the ball.
I'm going to do that. That would be more beneficial.
And then, does this get archived now?
I don't believe so.
No, it only gets archived if
so
you succeed.
So, kick the ball 2 spaces away.
Okay. So the ball's out of range.
Yeah.
That's good. And then I'll move Matt to sabotage. It's here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Do I want to go up in this? Do I want to dash? Yeah, let's dash.
You don't use your survival.
I use my survival.
That's always good.
1, 2, 3, 4. There's my dash. 1, 2, 3. I don't get 2 tokens. I only get 1 token. See if I can make that so I get 2 tokens.
Oh.
And then I could have...
Well, you don't have to run to the blind spot.
But I want to get more hits in.
Yeah.
So... Because it's a 6 plus with the shield. And the shield's the good thing to hit with.
Yeah, so it's hard to hit with the shield, but it's a good thing. 2 hits.
2 hits.
Nice. So you're no, that's good. That's the one you want to hit the shield
with. That's the one I want to hit the shield
That's actually perfect.
All right, first one.
Oh.
10 again.
Okay, so you get plus 1 survival.
I have max survival.
Okay.
And this is archived, right?
Yes.
And I wound.
Okay. It's a one.
It's an automatic
fail. So lose one survival.
What happened the other way?
That goes back into the deck. And you could spend a survival and go again.
Yeah, let's see if I use it.
You do use it.
I'll use it. Six plus.
Two hits.
Perfect hit does not give me anything.
Unfortunately.
No trap card yet.
Oh, God.
It's
coming up.
It's coming up.
So, filthy claws and hidden mandibles. So this is... They're both ground pounding. This one's ground pound and a basic action, so... This one first. Four.
Done.
Okay, so the monster performs ground pound. Roll a d10. Move the ball that much closer to him.
Does the ball keep moving once it's adjacent to him, or...?
Yeah,
the
monster sends a ground pound. Also, it's adjacent to the monster, suffer bash.
Alright, so I'm not down.
So that immediately ends. So you actually don't get that reaction card. It's actually a good thing. Move the ball 1d10 spaces towards the monster.
Just towards, alright.
So
it just moves next to him again.
That is correct.
So...
That is the end of our turn.
And we can't move it out of the way.
Yeah.
So he's going to swipe that around...
That's going to be pretty bad. Unless you spend a survival to run up and kick it with your other guy.
I have to spend two survival.
I know.
And if I don't roll high enough...
It's still going to happen anyway.
It's still going to happen anyway. I'd rather have the chance to... Well, first he's going to do this. At the start of every monster's turn, he's going to pick the stinky survivor. For other things, there's only one, which is me. Turn the face of target and perform baller.
So it's going to spin the ball around him. Which is going to hit all but me.
And then he's going to... So everyone's going to suffer 5 damage.
Everyone?
Oh, no. Then move... No, the baller just hits everyone.
Yeah.
Then he throws the ball at me.
Yes. And you get 5 damage.
Whoever it goes through.
Right. Fuck it. You could... Yeah. Roll high.
3. 1. 2.
That's just enough.
It would have been enough if it's...
Okay, so that worked out nicely.
That worked, so he's not doing that.
So you have no more survival left.
I have no more survival left. That used everything I had.
So next time we fight him, we just take all bow guys. Right?
Good. Alright, your turn to be a monster controller.
And this is the genius architect. Do not perform this card. Instead, the monster gently steps on a keystone. The tunnel network breaks in just the right place as all survivors suffer bash and 3-4 damage to the legs location. Really?
So we all suffer bash, so we're all knocked down.
Oh my god.
And I'll take 4 damage to the legs?
Yes.
Alright. You take 4 damage to the legs.
4 damage to the legs?
Is that where you had your heavy hit before?
No, it was not.
That was the last showdown.
Okay.
So now I have a heavy hit at both my legs and my arms.
Really? That's fucking terrible.
And then grapple.
That's awful.
And he's got your ground pound, so it moves adjacent to him again.
Strategy for DBK, don't get hit. DBK.
I need to roll 2 severe injuries.
No, just 1. You only roll once. Oh, both of them got it?
I have no... You didn't give me any armor for either character.
Do I have time to take a second?
Just wait a second.
No. What? No. No.
Donald Trump just died.
No!
Because Josh didn't have any armor.
He came with no armor! Don't even give me that stupid shit!
Me, Donald?
No.
I could have spent the survival to... No, I already dashed.
OG Donald Trump?
Yeah, OG Donald Trump.
But we just got him back!
We did just get him back.
Spend the survival to do what?
Dash.
No, it was...
Oh,
everyone
yeah,
took
it.
4 damage. There was no...
Yeah, you're right.
There was nothing you could do.
Yeah, you're right. You're right.
Everyone's
Trump is dead. Donald Trump...
Is it dead again?
He's that again.
Oh, no. Wait, that's a leg. It's two.
Two.
Oh. Two bleeding tokens.
Two bleeding tokens.
Trump's still alive!
You almost killed Trump for no reason.
You just got two bleeds.
Trump's
okay.
still alive.
Maybe naming a character Donald Trump is bad, and we're talking about killing Trump, and Trump is dead,
and
that's
and
bad.
Nine.
Very bad.
Game
this
two.
Is a game.
Really? So a 2-3 and a 9 give you the same fucking thing?
No,
we're okay. We're okay.
Splits.
No,
Matt is sabotage.
GG, no
my emotions can't take
no,
this.
No double dash, GG, no RE. Read.
I forgot that legs is the only one where a 2 doesn't kill you.
Yes.
The power of reading.
Okay.
Thank you,
Coy. Cannot kill zombie Trump.
Not yet.
It's the third coming of
Trump.
Are
we all technically knocked down?
No. Because we got knocked down on our turn.
I did too.
Bandage quick, 4 tokens is a lot.
So the 3.
Bandage
yeah.
quick.
Oh, it's 2 on each.
Yeah,
so
two on
we're
each.
Okay.
So, they're up. Trump
they're
is
up.
Down.
Trump
and
is down.
Matt is sabotage is down.
Yeah, Matt is sabotage is down. Oh, no, that is... That is not Matt is... That is, Matt shaves his head at 1 crit.
Okay.
That's Matt crit.
Do you have any survival to stand him up?
If we get an actual savior, we're gonna give him the blue life exchange rule. Dead, alive again.
But here's my survival.
Wish politics
Trump's
would
up.
Stop pivoting. Throw the stone.
Don't do it till the end of his turn in case any of his reaction caused ground pound.
Yeah.
So we don't have to mess with it
yeah.
multiple times.
So kick that fucking ball away. Oh, no, I see what you're saying.
Wait
oh,
till
no,
the end
I,
of
I got you. I thought you were referencing something
no.
else.
No.
That makes sense. Okay, so I'm going to move five spaces closer. And I'm going to use my Vespertine arrow.
Do you have any survival left?
Yes.
Do you want to check the hit location cards first and see what's there?
Oh, I see what you're saying.
Now may I go for a second? I beg of you?
Yeah.
Yes.
You want to use your that, and then if everything looks okay, you can serve and use your bow? Yeah.
Sure. I have
okay.
two survival. So yeah, so I'll do that. So the top three, and I put them back in any order? Or
yes, you put them back in any order. So. It's a 2?
It's a 3 speed, but if you put it as a
no,
second...
Well, I thought you used any arrow.
Oh, the arrow is a 2 speed, you're right. But you could put it as the second one, and I can do sniper. Actually, what does this do? Full move directly towards the attacker. The monster is adjacent to the attacker, picks them up, and leaps high into the air. The monster lands next to the resin dung ball and slams the attacker inside. Place the monster in any space adjacent to the ball. Oh. Put that on top.
Move directly towards the attacker. If the monster is adjacent to the attacker, it picks them up and leaps high into the air. The monster lands next to the resin ball, so he comes back next to us.
That's if it grabs me. Put that on top. I'm going to dash away, then I'm going to sniper bow him, and he's not going to be able to reach me. And I get rid of the trap card at the same time.
Okay.
Yeah. This works.
Okay. We should check the hit location first, but yeah.
I should have. So I wasted my dash. I wasted a survival there.
But you going to waste both survivals
yeah.
doing
yeah.
this.
So I'm going to... He's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7... Is that right? Oh no, he can still reach me. No, I can
yeah.
go here. I can go there.
Okay. So you're gonna snipe him?
So Zenith, I search the hit location deck. I put the trap card on top. I'm gonna use dash to move exactly 9 spaces away so I can sniper bow. I'm trying to trigger the trap card so he runs towards me and he shouldn't be able to do anything. Because he's not gonna reach me.
Yeah. Sniper bow!
Sniper bow! So I'm gonna sniper bow and watch, I'm gonna miss this. It's okay. So it's a +4 action, goes a 2+, it's a 4, that's a hit. Trap card. I'm doomed. Full move the monster directly towards me. If he's adjacent to me, he's not. The monster leaps high into the air.
Does he still do that?
It doesn't say. It just says, if the monster is adjacent to the attacker, then it picks them up and leaps high into the air.
Alright, so I'm going
to
say...
But then it says down here, place the monster in any space adjacent to the ball. So he's going to move back to the ball. but he doesn't actually grab me. I don't get any damage. Because he's not going to grab me. He's just going to run towards me and jump back to the card, I believe. Zenith, this is a weird one. So since I'm out of range, does he actually move back to his ball? Or... this one I'm slightly confused about. And I'll be right back because I have to get some water.
No.
As you read it, it sounds like the monster doesn't leap into the air. Oh, cool. So he stays...
nice! Okay.
Yes! Well, we can't attack. That's the only... it's harder for a stack, but it's okay.
No, now you know what you do, Josh?
Balcony says, I think it goes back to the ball.
Aw, that's bad.
Alright, see you, Balcony.
Thanks for joining us, Balcony. We'll miss you.
So what's the ruling?
I think Zena's reading the card. Yeah, it was only the one card, though. So...
over.
Oh, I'm trying to reach out while you're gone, because you take my phone and put it on the other side of the table.
You're in my spot. And you stuck out, like, all the way into the aisle way.
Yeah, because I hate you.
Okay, here's my ruling. It says if.
If, yeah.
Okay,
so I think... I think he stays there, which kind of...
since the monster is not adjacent to you, it doesn't leap into the air. So
yes.
Therefore, it does not...
go back to the ball.
Go back to the ball.
Thank you, Judge Zenith.
Judge Zenith.
It's like Judge Judy, but more entertaining.
You have successfully gamed one of the least gameable traps. Congratulations. Yes! High five!
Because we are retarded. thank you, Zenith, for the awesome bow, because I know you... fought for that bow.
Well, yeah, you're the reason that I wanted that bow is because I played the demo at Gen Con and I was reading it and like, wait a minute, this thing's awesome!
Alright, so I technically can try to hit it with my spear still.
Do it! And then we could have everyone else kick the ball.
Here. Which way do we want to kick the ball? You want to kick it this way?
So if you kick it this way and it goes a small amount, then I could have TP kick it as well without moving and then move closer to the Dungeon of Night.
Kick all the things.
Right,
kick
all
the balls.
I'm going to run up to him and hit it with my spear.
Nice.
Spear?
So it's a 6 plus.
One
hit.
Watch you get the trap. The iridescent back. Two. Turn to face directly away from the attacker.
He's technically, or you could move that way, doesn't really matter.
The monster beats its wings, all survivors in its blind spots are for knockback 7. No,
not in its blind spots though, so haha.
Ha.
Alright, I will push the ball with a crit mat. Oh, I get to move it 5 spaces. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, you crit it, nice.
Oh, I
basically
did.
Crit it.
It's still 5 spaces. So either Twitch can run over here, try to kick it this way more, or just...
Twitch is going to do damage.
Do you know how you can tell I worked on something? I proved how busted the equipment is and got nerfed, sometimes accidentally. I lobbied really hard to keep the DPK's gear super strong. I won those arguments except for the one I cared about most.
TP, do you have any survival?
One. The one that we saved.
You can dash to try to hit him. Switch his call though.
Yeah.
Wait, didn't we use it for something else?
No.
No, because you guys saved it. You got
it
back.
We used it for something else.
No. You spent this 4. That's really all you spent so far.
So you could spend a survival to dash to hit the Dung Beetle Knight, or you can just get closer. And then save your survival to... well, I mean, you could always... possibly still get it back. Kagrat says, I say be a little conservative. The fight can drag on a bit longer.
Not
from
that.
Zenith says, totally.
How much more health does it have?
6.
Yeah, we haven't been wounding it that
yeah.
much.
He has 6 health left, so he has quite a bit of health left. So.
So yeah, I'm gonna agree with them.
Save it.
So save it. I'm just gonna run you closer.
Do they want to run closer, or do they want to run up to the ball and hit it further?
Then they're not gonna get anywhere close enough.
That's
to
true.
It. They're the main damage guy.
Matt just asked you to kick him in the balls.
Yeah.
Okay. That went. The Trump doesn't go. Not that I know of.
I don't think so. This is the first time for us playing it, so I don't know. And Trump is still knocked down.
And I pushed it. I could technically run over.
Yeah.
I say I ran over my turn because there's no reason.
Okay, so now
to.
It is the
wait,
mom.
Trump. Is Trump has bleeds?
You want to heal Donald?
I would have to search. I can't
do
it.
Don't worry about it. It's fine.
If you move up next to me next turn, I can heal you instead of attack, but I don't know if that's worth it.
Cage says, the ball will be close to us next time it moves. I don't think it can be moved all the way back in one roll.
I don't think so.
No,
because
it would need to be a full 10 in 1-2.
Ikoi says, this is a virgin DPK fight.
Yeah, it can't get close
virgin.
Enough to do that other thing.
Right.
Boiling resin spit, closest knockdown survivor. Donald Trump. Doesn't say in range.
He skilled him.
Oh, this is not good. This is not good.
Technically, Donald Trump is getting... one of your characters is monster control. So
it would be him, yeah.
So he gets a insanity at least.
Do not underestimate how far the ball can be moved. Hoo boy.
this is problematic. 2 speed, 4 plus accuracy. He had no natural evasion, right?
Yep.
You might want to encourage dash before the attack happens.
Unfortunately, he's knocked down.
Oh, yeah, he's knocked down, so he can't. Oh, encourage dash. I already used the encourage with the one person I had survival with, so unless Twitch wanted to encourage. Oh, no, I have strength tokens I could use.
Who is this that we're talking about?
Too late.
Yep.
My fault. So, 5 damage. To the body. The searing hot spit chemically fuses into a hard shell. The target gains -2 movement tokens if this attack damages the legs locations, and -2 accuracy tokens if it damages the arms locations.
Bye, Donald.
Well, I roll a severe injury on the body table.
Oh.
Still roll low. He's okay.
10.
Oh,
you're knocked down.
God.
I'm knocked down. And I'm
you don't
already
get a bleed
knocked
token.
Down. I don't get a bleed token.
So Donald Trump is still alive. He's okay.
We can't lose Donald yet. It's getting emotional.
It is a move and attack, Ikoi.
Okay.
Woo!
Donald Trump gets up now.
He does get up now.
Does he?
You're never going to keep him down.
Okay.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Twitch can go punch it in the butt.
Twitch, punch it in the butt.
Always punch it in the butt. Let's do
always.
This.
Always. 2d10s.
2.
And it is an accuracy of 4 plus. Nice.
The RX and Cage, if you can roll. Cage rolled an 8.
1 hit. The iridescent arms.
Always
me
butt
punching.
Aren't the RX still here?
Donald Trump's gonna get knocked down.
RX rolled a 5.
That's still a hit. So I need 2 more d10s to be rolled.
Newt and.
Oh, wait, hold on. Wait,
no.
wait. Because they can't ever critically hit.
We can't.
Okay.
So, full move towards the attacker. If the monster's adjacent to the attacker, they suffer bash and knockback 7.
Wait, so
says
the rolls
unless
don't
it's
count?
A crit.
Yeah, but this is parry. This isn't first hit, so they can still go for this.
Oh, okay,
first.
You're right.
So, what's the first one?
First one is a 10, and the second one is a 3.
So, they crit the first one.
Yeah. Okay. So, if the attack...
Well, you can't crit.
Oh, you're right.
No. What was unlucky says?
Unlucky
says...
You
can't perform a critical wound.
Okay.
So, you do they do damage
They
him.
Do damage.
The monster stumbles backwards. It suffers knockback 3 directly away from the attacker. So, he gets...
Bash.
Knocked down.
Ikoi says, because the only real way to soft cancel an M&A is dash out of range, which is pretty dang tough most of the time since monsters got them legs.
Yeah. And perform ground pound. So 2. Right? No, 4.
Yeah, it's 1d4.
And what else does it say about ground and pound?
That's it.
All monsters adjacent, all people adjacent suffer bash, so that's...
Yeah. Ground?
Yes.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, that's already done.
Okay, so you don't get to attack the second location. And it is still our turn. I'm going to attack with the Vespertine bow. The Vespertine arrow. 2 speed, 6+ accuracy, lots of crits.
All the crits.
MD Haynes, thanks for following us. Really appreciate it.
What's a hit?
So my 10 was for nothing?
7 and 8.
I rolled a 7 and a 3.
Oh, I'm looking at the 8 there.
Shoshi wants to know, so my 10 was for nothing?
No, the 10 was actually good.
The 10 was wounded. It just the second die didn't do anything.
Okay. Which is good because it was a 3.
There's no crits at this location.
We're all natural.
Blaster, I think you're next. I'm gonna
and
pull
you have a
you
bunch of strength,
anyway,
don't
regardless.
You? Yeah, I have a bunch of strength. I have
and you haven't rolled yet.
I think that was what happened last time.
Yeah, 9+10. Yeah, that's
yeah,
a wound.
It's a wound.
So that gets discarded, and I gain a survival. I get a survival back.
Okay.
That got used.
When did you use that?
I just used it now.
Oh, I thought you were using the bow.
No, 2 speed for the arrow.
Okay.
Okay.
No.
What?
Then you didn't have enough strength. I thought you were using your bow.
Oh, you're right. So that's...
0.
0+9+4=13.
13, and it's... +6, so it's 18. He has -1, so 17.
Okay, never mind.
So you don't get that. You actually...
I lose a...
Lose a survival.
Yeah. Damn. Whoopsie. My fault.
Yes. Okay, so I guess if every time I crit, we'll go into the blind spot and attack?
We might want to kick the ball away.
I don't think... I can't get close enough with him.
Damn.
How many bleed tokens does Shunk have?
2.
2? Yeah, you're fine.
Yeah, he's fine for now.
I kick the ball away with, Mana Sabotage.
You can't kick it very far.
Can't, but...
No hits!
No hits. Alright, so that's that. I'm gonna try to... Dash. I use my survival. Dunk.
Did you kill it?
No.
So, I now have 5 tokens here, though.
Ah, so what does that mean? Oh, the next time you attack, it's really stupid.
Next time I attack, I add 1d strength and luck to the first hit location I hit.
Okay. That's ridiculous.
You're insane.
Okay, so unfortunately I think that's all of our turns.
Yeah.
It's turn for monster controller?
It is Mana Sabotage.
Yeah. I don't know where it is. Not sure where it is right now.
It's right here.
It's right there. So monster goes.
Do I want to check the AI cards? Is it worth the survival?
Maybe a survival. It's a 50-50 survival. Is it worth a half a survival? Is it worth a free?
Yes, it's a free. I get
the top
2.
So you want to read about what they...
The Genius Architect.
Oh, Genius Architect's Harper. Fucking terrible.
So we're going to leave Soldier Bass closest stinking threat, which is going to be me. So he's going to kind of run through everyone.
No, not necessarily. Yeah, he's going to run through everyone. Because it makes him take the most direct route, right?
Yeah, I mean, my one character could be fine because he can move over one and straight down. So he's going to hit. TP is going to get.
Knocked down.
Knocked down and knocked back. 5.
Yeah.
But he won't be adjacent to his ball.
No, he won't. He'll be very fucking close, but he won't be adjacent to it.
He'll do ground pound at the end. So I will get bash. That's fine. Yeah. All right, let's do that. All right, so him.
Genius
target
architect
me.
Is awful. That's...
So I get an extra sanity.
Yeah.
He's going to go here. He go 1, 2, 3, 4. They get knocked. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you guys are knocked down. It's a speed of 2. Accuracy is going to be 7+. Because I have 3 evasion.
Oh.
And it's a 4+.
Do you have a shield on that guy also?
Yeah, but I have to hit with it, though I technically could surge or dodge. So 7+, that's 1 hit.
What does it do after damage?
Bash, knockback 7, and bleed 1.
But it does 5 damage.
But it does 5 damage. I'm going to dodge it.
Yeah.
I use my survival.
Is that your last survival?
No, I still have 1 left.
Okay, that's good.
And I technically have 2 tokens left, too.
Ah, that's true.
Perform ground pound.
Roll d10.
Oh, everyone suffer. I suffer bash.
Yeah.
So I'm like that now.
Meow.
And there's 2 spaces back. 2. Yeah, there you go.
There.
Okay. And now it's our turn.
Or does it technically just go here?
I think it just
stays
there.
Okay. So it's our turn.
Donald Trump stands up.
Donald Trump stands up.
Which one?
The OG Trump.
Call him OG Trump.
OG Trump's gonna go kick the ball.
Just wait.
What?
End of the turn.
Oh, you're right.
We really need to get rid of the next AI card.
I can sniper bow it.
Do you want to check the hit location and then throw the Founding Stone with Trump? Possibly. If we need to.
I think that's a good idea.
So, check the top 3.
Okay. Monster guides its attack into the side of the resonant making it melee enemy. Unless the attacker is deaf, lose all positive attribute tokens and survival.
That's horrible.
Iridescent abdomen. Perform basic action against the attacker. But it's got a critical, gain a... Oh, I should be looking at the critical. Gain a random resource. Gain +1 survival and the monster's knocked down.
Oh, yeah. Put that on top.
Yeah.
And then fucking...
Well, what's this one, too? Gain a random resource. They vomit. If you spend 4 survival, you get a permit. But no one has 4 survival.
So,
okay.
Yep, that's good. So
I am going to go with Donald Trump now, and I am going to throw my founding stone.
Spend your strength token, because then you can still go later to push the ball away. Because you can't move. Or you can move and then throw it, and then again. So you're going to go here?
Yeah.
Throw it.
Founding stone.
Bam!
So I get +1 survival, so Donald Trump, OG, now has 1 survival.
Okay.
That's why I didn't want to spend this token.
Okay.
And then, monster's knocked down, which is very important, and then I'm going to kick the ball. 1 whole space.
It's not just no anymore, though.
So now I'm going to move closer with... Yeah, that's fine. With Bill Clinton, and now Bill Clinton is going to attack with the Vespertine bow. And this has the potential to really do some damage here.
We might be able to kill him this round. 3 hits. 3 plus hits.
3 hits. Please no trap. Okay.
That's an interesting question.
What?
Do these still count?
I don't believe they do.
Because they're reactions?
Is Zenith still here? Zenith, are you still here? We've got a quick question for you, if you are. Do the green cards, when the monster's dung ball... If the monster's dung ball is not adjacent to him, do those happen if the monster is knocked down? Oh, good. He says he am. So Zenith, is that the case? If the monster's knocked down, do those if the ball is not adjacent to the monster, the little green card, the green flavor text there, do
that's,
those still
there's
happen?
There's that symbol. Oh. Ooh.
Yeah. If he's knocked down, that's my concern.
Stop trying to cheat.
I'm trying to play by the rules. That's the thing. I mean,
the monster stands up when it draws an AI card.
No. These are
the hit locations. So they say if the ball's not next to him, draw a new hit location if the ball's not next to him. Does that matter that he's knocked down?
Can TP show us an example of such a card? So, for example, this one here. Show him that, TP.
Remove to my beautiful face.
So this is the hit location card. It's got the green text at the top. Does that happen if the monster is knocked down?
I'm so shaky because it's so zoomed in.
Be nice if it didn't.
What does knocked down say? And Foggy Planet, did we say that? Thank you for the follow for them?
Hey, Foggy Planet, thank you
thank
for following
you.
Us.
What does knocked down say?
I'm reading.
No, reactions, I think.
He says, okay. Giving you two rulings.
The monster's knocked down, cancel all reactions, and putting reactions that may be beneficial to survivors. This does not cancel critical wound effects.
One, by the letter of the rules, it's not a reaction, so it should happen.
Mm-hmm. And two is, fuck it.
Probably it shouldn't happen because it doesn't make sense. Maybe?
You just insulted his baby.
No. I'm just saying, like, if he's knocked down, how is he summoning the ball back to him?
Backtrack, yeah. You take your foot out of your mouth.
But it tastes so yummy.
I know it does. Two, by the spirit of the rules, the monster probably wouldn't crush the keystone while knocked down, so it doesn't happen. So is that an official over...
Can you show separation and anxiety real quick? While the monster is not adjacent to the resin ball, it gains separated and gains that. If an AI or hit location card has that, only apply those actions, effects, or special rules if the monster is separated, otherwise ignore them.
And he's saying the spirit of the game that he would not do it.
Okay. So
am I showing this?
Yeah. So we do have official Judge Zenith ruling that those don't happen. Too late here.
Spirit of the rules.
Yeah. I think without an official ruling from Adam, I'd say the monster does not crush a keystone. Okay, cool.
We're going to get a tweet in 5 minutes from Adam.
I know.
I wish.
You all die.
No, you're playing wrong. You die.
Okay, so then it doesn't matter what order we do these in. I have 10 strength with the bow and my...
He's minus one toughness. So anything besides a one.
Yeah. That's a wound. That's a crit. Gain one random Dung Beetle Knight resource.
As long as you hit this last one, we're good. He's dead.
We won.
What?
We won.
What?
We have no deaths.
What?
Oh, you want to read what we got? It looks really cool.
We got the Century Shell. This ancient and mineral-rich armor plate is covered with razor wind scratches. You may spend this as if it were a Scarab Shell resource. Mr. Purple, I thought the spirit of the rules was fuck you, die.
But
holy crap.
Say this. This happens.
What?
Oh no, this is impervious. We can't wound.
Oh, you're right. You're right.
So
he technically isn't dead.
He's technically not dead.
No. You do not.
He's
got one health.
Matt, before you start calling people dead like OG Trump and DBK, can you feel their pulse first? Can you make sure before you make an official ruling?
But technically, just say if we did follow the spirit rules, we discard and join a hit location, they would have died.
Yeah.
The ball would have moved towards the target, which would have been fine.
He would have ground pounded. But I'm not adjacent.
He's not adjacent. So technically, if we even did that, you would still kill him. If you would have killed him, actually. If we follow
the right way.
Depending what...
So technically he still has one health.
Technically has one health.
By going with Judge Zenith's rules.
So, Zenith actually screwed us over on that?
Do you want to shoot again? Or...
I can't. I don't have any more survival.
You have a strength token.
I do have a strength token. I will do that.
Because you have the best chance of wounding, because you have...
Should I sniper bow it?
Yes.
Okay. Because
we only need one.
I'm going to spend a strength token as a survival, and I'm going to sniper bow it. Rolled a 3, that's a success.
Wait, I did what now?
That was pointless to sniper bow it, really. Unless I hit the trap card.
Unless you hit the trap
card.
So what did
that
do?
Oh, no, we actually would have drawn a new hit location card if we went by those cards, so we would have been able to kill it on that turn.
Yeah. So we had
so
a start
helping
this...
you?
So
by helping
us,
us,
it hurt us a little bit.
It's okay, though.
I still kill it.
You still kill
oh,
it?
Yeah, I could have thrown my founding stone. That would have been smart. I have a founding stone.
No, you already tossed it.
Trump was supposed to come with a founding stone.
Okay. So this is...
Yeah.
Technically still out. Okay, we kill it.
Oh, wow, I would have got +3 courage. Whatever, he's dead. We got it. We did it.
First chance. Party of five.
Party of five.
Everyone lives.
Hashtag party of five.
Hashtag
we had a naked man with a founding stone. Well, he had a cloth on.
Yeah.
Naked.
Is it easier with the fifth? Or is it harder?
It's technically slightly easier.
Because he didn't scale up. So we had an extra guy to do some silly stuff with. Like, we had the extra founding stone throw, and he kicked the ball a couple times.
Yeah, but it wasn't like...
Hug it out, Matt.
We did it. So, what do we get? Everyone, please up your hunt XP by one.
Both my guys leveled up.
And OG Donald Trump just leveled up, guys.
OG Donald Trump.
All right, so I'm going to roll 2d10s for
Snarflix, you're taking level 3 Dung Beetle Knight.
No!
I rolled an 8.
An 8 is a random fighting art.
Is it?
Yes.
I thought it was all
it's up to 6. It's something else. 90% sure it's random.
Oh, I could have done
this. Oh, I'm sorry. Is that the second age or the first age? First age, 8, yeah, it's a fighting art.
Right, and my other character is a 3.
A 3 is +1 permanent strength.
Okay, so when I crit, it gets a +1 strength.
And I rolled 18. Ooh, +1 permanent accuracy with OG Donald Trump.
Because he needs more accuracy. Oh, no, that's
OG. OG Donald Trump. So OG Donald Trump has +1 accuracy, +1 strength.
Newt says from now on, from now on out, volunteer Mo for everything that would potentially kill someone.
I agree.
Matt is sabotage.
Got sneak attack. When you attack a monster from its blind spot, add 4 strength for that attack.
What's the guy with acid palm?
Oh my god. Oh, so he's gonna give stinging attacks to the monster's buttholes.
Yeah.
Yes, Cage and Nudie, I know you guys are gambling addicts. Who got the last hit?
That would be...
OG Trump?
No.
No, Bill Clinton.
Bill Clinton.
Okay. Bill Clinton.
Bill.
So what
Inquiry
what,
Newt
what
bent
50
and won 153 points.
What do we get back? The group investigates the large resin dung ball and the network of tunnels beneath the battleground. Inside the ball, they find a caustic but mineral-rich substance. That's poop.
Your poop.
Poop. Rolling aside the ball, they find passageways leading deeper underground. After collecting rewards, spelunking of death.
All right, so what do we get?
We get 6 basic resources. We get a lot of stuff for the Dung Beetle Knight.
He wasn't horrible.
You shut your whore mouth.
He was hard.
He was very hard.
He was hard, but he wasn't like Lion Knight. Fuck
Lion
you
Knight
up,
was
tear
really,
you apart.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
I like the ball.
Also, we couldn't have done it without the Sword of Silence and the Vespertine Bow.
Yes.
It would have been impossible.
6 basics? I'm going to read these off as well.
Oh, no. It is time to spelunk. 6 basics. So we got a monster bone, a love juice, a monster hide, a monster organ, and a broken lantern.
Okay.
We also get 4 Dung Beetle Knight resources.
All right, so we get 4 more. So you want to read off the ones we got from the fight?
We also got from the fight the Century Shell and the Elytra.
Do you want to read what those are? Because they have kind of a...
So the Century Shell is a hide iron, and the Elytra is a bone hide organ. We also got the Sentry Fingernails, which are bone, the Compound Eye, which is an organ, the Scarab Shell, which is hide, and a Scarab Wing, which is an organ.
That's interesting. You get 3d10 of sanity if you assume.
Jesus.
You assume
okay, very cool. We also get 2 Caustic Preserved Dung Strange Resources. Shochi's like, but you had 5 people! Agent Vetter, yeah, they were cheating. Ecoy, Lion Knight is easier when you figure out his game. Yeah, that's true. We were completely in the dark the first time around, and
second time we fought him, we had 1 survivor.
Yeah, literally 1. We actually did pretty well.
We did pretty well considering we had 1 survivor. What am I getting? Preserved?
2 Caustic Preserved Dung Strange Resources.
Okay. 2 of those. That's a ton of resources.
That is a ton of resources. The first time the settlement defeats the Dung Beetle Knight, after they innovate storytelling... Do we have storytelling?
No.
Okay, never mind. So now we are spelunking of death. The group investigates the monster's network of tunnels and are inspired by the rich vegetation. If your settlement does not already have it, gain the subterranean agriculture innovation.
Hi, Nicholas.
Bye-bye. Subterranean agriculture. Okay. So, we can choose to investigate up to 4 victorious survivors. One at a time, we roll d10s and go on this table below. A 1 is bad. Otherwise, everything else looks good. No, not necessarily.
What?
If you roll high, you have a higher chance of dying eventually. But you can get some really fucking cool stuff. So, do we want to do it with anyone?
YOLO.
Yeah, Zenith says you might want to be careful with your trumps.
I'll sacrifice Matt Shapes when I crit because he really doesn't have much. And he has -1 gear slot.
Bill Clinton has +2 strength. Do I want to sacrifice him?
No, I think just
we
Matt
could
Shapes.
Do it with multiple people.
I know. I think we should just do it
well, with we do it with one at a time, so you can...
So...
Roll a d10. I don't want to nominate the trumps.
2.
A 2. You find the remnants of an abandoned resin dung ball. Gain 1 preserved caustic dung beetle knight resource. Oh, the... You got... Oh, that's this. Okay.
Okay. So... Do they want to nominate Trump to do this?
I don't think
there's
they
a good
to.
Chance that he could
Gundark
die.
Says do it. Oh, you stopped Gundark. Looking, Gundark. Thanks. And now he's joining the queue. What are you doing? What are you doing?
Isn't he watching that other stream?
Ecoy says you got to do it with one person at least for funds.
We did it for one person.
Ecoy says that was almost death.
That was almost dead.
Almost doesn't count. Inquiring said, Newt says, and not Trump. Kagari says, send Slick Willy. I agree with Kagari. I kind of want to send Slick Willy in.
You had to do it with one person's fun.
We did.
Okay. Do it with OG Trump.
I'm going to do it with Slick Willy first.
8.
Oh, God. Beneath a passage of bones, you find a secret entrance and are compelled to attempt the Trial of Valor. Okay.
9.
Oh shit. You have passed and may attempt the Trial of Wits. Oh shit.
You may attempt? You add your courage to this too.
I did.
You rolled a 9?
Yeah.
No courage?
I added 1 courage. I'm attempting the Trial of Wits.
Oh, okay.
I have 1 understanding. It's so tempting! How wily is Willy?
If your understanding was higher.
If my understanding was higher, I'd say, oh god, he's like, oh shit, he's going all the way. Fuck, I don't know what to do! Do it, Matt. Oh god.
Do it. Natural 10. 6.
7. Fuck, no! No! Oh, god damn, you die, your corpse is mysteriously found in the settlement. Literally, if I had 1 more! Ah!
Wait, exciting. So what happened?
He died.
I died.
Wait, which
Bill Clinton died.
Okay, as long as it's not OG Donald Trump. Do not mess with OG Donald Trump.
It was so close to being perfect.
You did. You did.
It
That's
was
what Zenith says. You did.
So close to being perfect.
Oh, you got a +1. Oh, yeah, the +1 luck would have been awesome.
Yeah, with the Vespertine stuff?
I don't even know what the 10 thing is.
Yeah, I have no idea. If your settlement already had any of the 3 fighting or 2 choice instead.
So close.
That's it. We left with 4, we returned with 4. We sacrificed Bill Clinton for Donald Trump.
Worth it.
And Hillary Clinton became Donald Trump. How poetic.
I thought it's kind of beautiful in its own fucked up way.
Yeah.
Oh, God.
So that was the Dung Beetle Night.
Yeah. So.
Oh goodness, that was fun.
That was interesting.
Wow.
Oh wait, so that means Bill Clinton. Sadly.
Can you describe the emotional trauma of losing Bill?
I'm really upset just because that was going to be his first level in bow proficiency, and he had +2 natural strength.
Isn't this so beautiful?
Well. Other than that, I don't really care. Bill wouldn't live to see his wife possessed by Donald Trump have sex with himself.
Oh, can you grab the
on top of Mo's
set
corpse.
Of events?
And
yeah.
The turn of events makes me feel confused. Can't wait for the rumors to spread in the settlement that Clinton became Trump, or that Trump is slowly taking over all the other sides.
So we went with Bill and came back with another Trump.
Yeah. His face is filled with wonderment when, like, when he was hitting those balloons at the dance thing. That he died.
Oh, Jesus.
At least he died happy.
Ooh, we can make
important.
The wet resins crafter. I don't know what that
ew.
Is. So we get...
You're a wet resin crafter.
4 endeavors for coming back. Plus another 2 for Bill's death.
Yes.
So we have 6 endeavors.
Correct.
All right, Matt.
Blinging mist!
Control a D10, please.
No. This. Oh my god. Oh my god.
We can technically not do it because we do have guidepost.
I won't do it.
I know.
Because we have like our best survivors right now.
Okay, so Blaster, will you roll this for
you
us?
You kind of missed. Fuck. Oh god.
Exclamation point. Roll D10.
Trump settlement.
What the hell is this? This is year 8.
Oh my.
So, yeah, this would. That we just finished 8, so this would be going to year 9.
Oh, we have guideposts, so we can't time travel.
Oh, we can't.
No, we can't.
We can't do it.
No
doing yeah. it.
I mean,
we rolled an 8.
That would have done it too.
We can't do it.
Oh my god,
we can't do it.
Oh, that's so upsetting. Oh, the light from the lantern halberd cuts through the mist and guides the survivors back to the settlement. Discard this event and draw a new one.
We draw a new event?
Yeah. Oh my god, we were so close to having the Trump settlement.
Can you be sure of things before you announce them?
And I completely forgot about it. I thought that it was optional with the guidepost.
All right, Matt, grab another one.
So, we had the clinging mist, which if you roll a 8, 9, or 10, which we roll an 8, you get lost on your way back, and you either have to depart on another hunt immediately, or you can make a new settlement with the returning survivors.
And
so
all the frickin' resources
all,
we got.
All the resources and gear we currently have. So we would have had the 2 Trumps, and,
2 Rise
and the 2 Mats, all great gear. However, we had a guidepost, and the guidepost allows us to come back safely.
What if the two? What if they were not a male and a female?
So
you also
you,
get the first
start,
day settlement again.
Yeah, you fart. You start the first day settlement again,
okay.
So you actually get like 10 random new survivors.
Okay,
right, so we would have actually restarted our campaign, essentially, with these 4 survivors in this gear, and you've been completely overpowered for the beginning of it.
Yes.
So why, what was it that prevented us from doing it?
We had the guidepost.
Which is?
Remember what Bernie Sanders got impaled on?
Yeah.
This is really like political. So Bernie Sanders' death allowed us to prevented a Trump settlement.
Prevented Trump from forming its own colony?
Yes. So Bernie Sanders sacrificed himself for that.
All right, what's
thank
her name?
Thank you, Bernie. I think.
Cracks in the ground.
I don't know.
A low rumbling fills the settlement. Small cracks in the earth widen to a fissure that belches up hot, foul-smelling vapor. Need a D10 to be rolled.
I need a D10.
This is not good at all. This is really terrible.
Mr. Purple, if you could roll that
for
us.
This is awful.
I'm going to roll high, it's okay.
Let's get high off
or 2.
Feel the burn. 2.
Everyone has the same movement.
Everyone needs to roll.
Nightbot timed out Mr. Purple for 5 seconds. Stop spamming words and phrases. What?
We need them to roll another
D10. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Oh, because of no.
Zenith laughing.
No.
Oh, Blaster, don't worry. As long as you roll when we call on you, it automatically puts you back into the queue.
We need a D10.
Why'd you ban... What the fuck did you do?
Twitch proxy, did you?
So, yeah, D10.
It should trouble you.
Zenith?
Oh, God, Zenith.
Zenith, don't do this to us. Wait, so what happened with the 2?
You'll find out.
Is OG Trump okay?
We'll find out. It's one of the Trumps.
4.
Roll
again.
Nicholas is gone.
One more time, Zenith. Or someone else.
Blaster.
With the blaster.
Blaster, can you do this for us, please? Roll high. I think roll high.
It doesn't matter.
No, we cannot have both trumps at the same time.
No, we can't.
But we wanted to make the settlement free again. 7.
Original Donald Trump.
The original Donald Trump falls into a crack in the ground and is dead.
No!
Oh, no! No!
So he came alive just to sacrifice Bill Clinton, save us from the dung beetle, and then just
bored.
Fall into the hole.
Yeah. I am so sad. The original Trump is dead.
So we got 4 endeavors, 6 endeavors. This is technically the settlement, so
he
7
died
endeavors.
For your thing. He's basically Jesus.
So we have 7 endeavors.
All the babies?
But OG Trump is dead again. Actually, no. He is not even in the graveyard.
He's dead forever?
He's turned into a pile of goop.
No!
Scoop.
He actually becomes a flesh monolith.
So
that's what it says.
He can never come back again.
He is essentially a giant pillar of flesh in the middle of our settlement.
He died.
Well, he fell in a crack, so he's
hubris,
a.
He died for my slain DBK. It's Zenith's fault. I mean, it's poetic, but Zenith's the one that rolled
it,
honestly.
Well, I rolled a 4, and you rolled a 4. So
yeah,
Zenith rolled a 4. So it was both trumps.
Because both
maps
rolled
7. And that's why we re-rolled. As a tiebreaker.
But you guys have the better Donald Trump right now.
You do have the better Donald Trump.
That's what you get Zombie Trump for following the guidepost back instead of wandering off.
That is true. If the guidepost... I blame Bernie Sanders for this.
Also, after being thwarted by Sanders Quarks, it's Sanders' fault. Sanders' fault that he died.
It really is Bernie Sanders' fault.
Oh, God. All right.
It's so...
At least you have a flesh statue remembering Trump in your settlement.
With a Trump there.
There's such parallels between reality and this game.
Yeah. So Donald Trump can stand and stare in awe at his own flesh monolith.
Yeah. Sounds like something that would happen in Tort's real life.
So what's on the agenda?
I think we need to do just Gorm Climate.
Okay.
Oh, I never put this on anyone, but we have that.
I never put that up.
You know what's going to happen now, right? We're going to lose all of our resources.
We have that resources, though. That's not in storage. So
we don't have much for too many resources in storage.
Where are you going?
Where are you going?
Like, this is the last thing that we're doing. I don't understand where he went.
It's like the NYC Donald statue.
If we got a savior, we name him George Washington.
Fitting if the lantern festival is enabled.
Where'd you go, Josh?
Where'd you go?
I forgot to copy some of the hunt events for my old sheep.
Tweet this at Adam, folks. He might enjoy it.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how to sum this up into
100
characters.
Alright, so... did you guys do a roll for
Gorm Climate?
Gorm Climate.
No. Because you said, hold on a second, you ran in the other room.
Where's Gorm Climate?
I don't know. TP, I need a D10 to reroll, please.
Oh, I wasn't in the deck. Oops.
So, sum this up for me.
Page roll of 5. We have Pubble. The survivors huddle inside as the razor winds and sickening lightning pummel the settlement. Add +2 to endeavor results at home innovations this year.
But I don't think we can't do any home endeavors this year.
God damn it.
I don't think there's anything at the home to do.
Isn't making babies? What are you
no,
doing?
No, that's not a home endeavor.
It's okay, Gorm Climate was a nothing.
So we can't do, like, partnership.
Okay.
And we don't have any of the sub ones.
Okay, that's fine.
So that's fine. Alright, so that's that.
So that's it, I think, right?
Innovation.
Innovate.
Always be innovating.
Always be innovating.
All right, so grab four innovation cards.
1, 2, 3, 4. We have Korea, Nightmare Training, Cooking, and Albedo.
So ask Twitch what they want to do.
Need your coffee to stop dropping my stuff. Yes, I do. You want an explanation?
Just start putting a poll together.
Okay.
And then we'll explain it after you get the poll up.
Korea, that's
one
C-H.
One second. What's the question?
What to innovate. Korea, C-H-O-R-E-I-A.
Mm-hmm.
Nightmare Training.
And?
Cooking.
Uh-huh.
And Albedo.
And what?
A-L-B-E-D.
B-E-D?
Oh.
Albedo. All right.
So I'll give an explanation now that she has the pull up. So first
also,
off... So, description. Yes, I'm getting there.
Sorry. Did it wrong. Continue.
We have Korea. So it is a forbidden dance sequence. So you can spend two endeavors and do the spider dance. Nominate a male and female survivor, roll a d10. 1 through 7 is beautiful dancing. 8 through 9 is you get the male survivor, the harvestman fighting art. And then a 10+ is death touch.
What's death touch?
The female survivor devours the male survivor. The male survivor is dead. The female survivor gains half the male survivor's hunt XP, rounded down. One of their fighting arts and the Death Touch secret fighting art. I feel like that's something Trump would do.
Can I have the cards that you've done reading them so I can put them in for him?
Yeah. Then we have Albedo, which is spend two survivors, two endeavors, and once this lands your near, and then 1 through 2, returning survivors lose one level of weapon proficiency. 3 through 9, gain 1 Gorm Brain Gorm resources for spending 4 organs. And then on a 10... returning survivors change one negative attribute modifier of their choice to 0. It's interesting if anyone has minus. I don't think anyone does.
Like if we got the
minus
long
1.
Witch.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a good card.
We have cooking, which allows us to do the cooking story event. And then we have nightmare training, which this is always a solid one to do. I like nightmare training.
Okay, can I have one second?
And here's the other two.
It's hard to read.
There.
Text.
You're a text. But my vote's for Nightmare Training.
Yeah.
How about you, Josh?
Nightmare Training's good. We could use cooking for stuff. We do have a couple of vermin resources.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's used for cooking.
Right, right.
Yeah.
What about UTP? Nightmare Training. Nightmare Training. Can you read Nightmare Training? Ham is a little blurry. Give me Nightmare Training, TP.
Yeah,
come in.
Nightmare Training, I can do it.
Okay.
Nope, can't do it.
Yeah. So Nightmare Training is you spend an endeavor and lose 3 survival and roll a d10. So if you roll a 1, you spend a survival or die. If you roll a 2 through 7, you spend a survival and roll again, if you want. 8 through 9, you get +1 level of weapon proficiency, and on a 10+, you gain +1 permanent accuracy or strength, which is very, very good. Equoi Planet, Penot, says cooking is poopy.
Cooking, well, you could cook poopy.
You could cook poopy.
Right now, Nightmare Training is winning by a long shot.
Okay, so we're going to do Nightmare Training.
Okay.
Okay.
And I believe that's everything, no? Or do we have anything else to do?
No, that is it for this year. We are going to be fighting the Kingsmen next year. So we'll probably be doing 2 years next.
Okay.
It's going to be Nemesis and...
Yeah.
Is it going to be a really quick game?
Super quick.
Kingsmen shouldn't be too bad.
It
really shouldn't, though.
I'm mocking it.
But yeah, so anyways, this has been Twitch Game...
Wait.
We have a giveaway.
Okay, well, I was going to say this is the end of this.
Oh, do whatever you want.
Do what you want. You
can. So this has been Twitch Plays Kingdom Death. We got through Lantern Year 7 and 8. We fought the Screaming Antelope, beat the crap out of it. And then we managed to survive against the Dung Beetle. It's funny, we didn't actually lose anyone to the Dung Beetle Knight. We lost someone from the last part of investigating the Dung Beetle Knight's tunnels, and then friggin' cracks in our own ground. So the ground killed more people than the Dung Beetle Knight did.
Yeah, that's true.
But yeah, so join us next week for the you know, lantern year 9 and 10. We're probably going to get through 2, because we're going to be fighting the Kinsmen. It's a nemesis encounter. It usually goes a little quicker. But so right now, if you guys haven't had a chance to do so yet, please quickly go buy your tickets. We're doing a giveaway right now.
Right now.
Right now.
Right now.
So I'm just going to finish up with the rest of the stream stuff before we announce the winner. If you're not familiar with it, Revlo's been spamming it. You can...
Spamming.
Exclamation mark, ticket, space, and then the quantity of tickets.
Exclamation point giveaway, and I'll put it right in chat.
Right now. Right now.
And you can get your tickets
Stop
for the giveaway.
The table because you're making the camera
show. Oh, sorry. Get the giveaway. Get your tickets in because we're going to be doing that in a few seconds here. That is for a sci-fi
Twilight Night. It's a tongue twister.
We got it from Gen Con. Kingdom Death minifigure pack there. And it is signed by the Pootsman.
Going to give everyone a bonus 10 points.
Because why not?
Go get your tickets if you want it.
And we did this because we hit our 600 viewer, or 600 follower. Thank you. Brain fart. 600 follower goal, but we wanted to wait until this stream because it is a Kingdom Death related giveaway. So we thank you all for joining us for this. Join us on Thursday. We're going to be doing our How to Play session at 8 p.m. And that is going to be teaching Dungeons & Dragons 5.0. How to make a character. So that's what we're going to be starting out with. It's going to be like a little mini-series we're going to put together there.
And then the week after that, we're going to do how to build a session and have Twitch actually build a...
A campaign.
And hopefully...
A one-shot.
Yeah. Around that time, hopefully, we'll hit our next goal, which is 700 followers. And that will give us the ability to give away a player's handbook.
Well, we have a bunch of stuff to just give away now.
Well, yeah.
So we're just going to be giving that away.
But we're doing D&D.
We'll see what
we're
doing.
It's
D&D. We'll figure it out.
We have a D&D player's handbook signed by Matt Mercer. If you guys are awesome, maybe we'll give it away.
I heard Poots. It's on the bottom of the wall minis.
But yeah, Poots actually signed the card of this giveaway.
Yeah.
For Twitch Game Night specifically.
Exclusive.
It's like the picture behind Matt signed by Zenith.
Yeah, Zenith.
Concept art. Anyway, so we are not going to have our normal Pathfinder stream on Saturday.
We're going to be at Treasure Coast Comic Con.
Yes.
So if anyone's in the South Central Florida area, please feel free to stop by in Port St. Lucie. Come check it out. We're going to have a little booth set up. We're going to be there Saturday and Sunday, and we're going to be talking on a panel as well. We're going to be doing our best to try and stream out of there.
So we might be streaming from there. And we're also going to be at Animate Florida on Friday, probably, and we might also be streaming from there
as well.
I'll have details.
We like doing things last minute.
That's how we roll. And then, if anything, join us back here next week.
On Monday,
we're going to be doing a quick redo of the spotlight of
Tales from the Tavern.
We're
going to play it. We're just gonna focus on the gameplay. Stop, you know, BSing as much.
Get the Kickstarter link for that.
I just did.
Oh, you did.
And Mark says that anyone who donates tonight from the stream, or anyone who backs tonight from the stream, he's gonna kick back 10% to us. And you know, every all the tips, anything we get kicked back, it really goes to help improve the stream. It helps us buy giveaways for you guys. It helps us buy more equipment. Funds more streams, so we really appreciate all the support, and if you were thinking about backing them, please back them tonight, because it would help us too.
Helps us out too, and then, honestly, everything that we get towards our stream basically goes back into the stream and either improving it or giving back to you guys, so we don't really pocket anything on it.
And if you guys...
We really don't. To dye my hair blonde,
You actually lost money on
it. I'm losing money on it. We don't pocket anything.
It was the fun of the stream.
Yeah.
But otherwise, next week on Tuesday, then we have our continuation of Twitch Plays Kingdom Death. So, quick shameless plug.
Mm-hmm.
Follow us on Twitch, Twitter, YouTube, Facebook, and chat with us in Discord if you're so inclined, if you want to talk with us some more. Mostly them, too. Not me. I'm not really in Discord ever.
So, it's the best. It's like the stream minus math.
Yeah,
thanks.
But I think, drumroll please, it is time to announce the winner of the drawing.
And don't forget to join us back for the other streams this week, because we have a ton of stuff to give away. We have one giveaway every stream this week, thanks to Vile Genius Games.
Mm-hmm.
So let's go back to Revelo.
I'm giving a little shout out to Loaded Dice for the
class.
Oh, yeah. Thank you so much. These are awesome. Back them too.
They're currently on Kickstarter right now as well. It is like an RPG glassware set.
Let me see if I can pull
it's
that.
Really cool. I'm definitely going to be back.
And we'll be meeting one of the guys from them at Treasure Coast.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, cool.
Yeah,
yeah, I think Mark said that he was going to be there. And, oh yeah, I remember Mark said yesterday that there's a stretch goal for Tales from the Taverns where if they get to it, they're going to be giving a shot glass with each of the premium backed ones as well. So that goes along because the game is, you know, it can be played as a normal board game, but it's got a drinking variant that pairs with it quite nicely.
Okay, so we're going over to the contest. It's time to go ahead and close.
All bet
ticket
purchases.
So, it's the end of it, guys. Sorry. And we're going to draw a winner. One time this time.
Lucy,
one,
stop.
Two, three.
And the
Dead
is...
Pickle!
Dead Pickle!
Dead Pickle!
Dead Pickle!
Dead Pickle just joined us for the first time tonight, I believe. Ben's already won something.
There you go.
Congratulations, Dead Pickle.
Awesome.
So, Dead Pickle, we're going to whisper you and try to get some
it
of your...
It should actually be on there. They should be able to enter it, so... But we'll contact you if we need it.
Yeah. So yeah, we'll contact you so we can get your shipping information there, and we will be sending you a sci-fi Twilight Night for Kingdom Death with that is signed by Bootsman.
Yeah.
And so yeah, we've got giveaways planned for this entire week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks.
Shut up,
Better. We've got 8 million things.
Better just said it was rigged.
It was rigged?
Oh, what does Red Dice Games think about that?
I wonder.
Thank you, Drake. 49091.
Thank you for following.
For following?
Yeah, if it was rigged, Cage would have won.
It's statistically possible, Better. Just because you had a better chance doesn't mean it was a guarantee. That's the math, dog.
Can we see a pic of the Mighty Signature before it's gone forever? I mean, it's been opened for him to sign it, so I don't think there's a problem in actually...
Josh is going to get his greasy fingers all over it.
We have a future figure too giveaway.
We do have a second one. It's a different figure, but it is also signed
and
by Bootsman himself.
You know what?
Don't break shit.
I don't have the cards in here. They're somewhere else.
What do you mean?
Josh lost
else?
The cards.
No, they're not. Oh, they're in the other box.
He just shoved them all together.
Because they brought one box with us.
If you know what I mean.
So there you go.
Can I have it?
Yeah.
For me? Okay.
Yes.
Okay. This is a beautiful. Signed by Poots.
The Poots Man.
It says thank you, TGN, Gen Con 2016, and that is AP, his signature. He is awesome.
That's funny. Capper's like, why do you have four of those?
Four of those?
To Inquiring New. Because Inquiring New said, I didn't enter, I have four of those. Like, when I mess up on painting, and also there's two weapon options. Makes sense. Logical.
Fair enough.
Yeah, so thank you all for joining us. Really appreciate it. Please join us for our other streams. And stay tuned for more giveaways. Vile Genius Games has got a lot of stuff donated to us to give away on the stream.
Yeah, we might get some stuff this weekend. We'll see what happens.
So yeah, this weekend we might get some other stuff too. So there's definitely a lot of giveaways coming you everyone's way. So please stay tuned. Watch, earn points, get the tickets, bet. I know TP likes to. And good night to everyone. Thank you for joining us. So, this is Twitch Game Night signing off. I'm Matt.
I'm Josh.
I'm TP, and thanks for joining us. Goodbye.
No. You're retarded.